Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, to Bazemore-Hyder Stadium. I'm your host, Mike Slater. Sitting next to me is my co-host, Trey Williams. Today, we bring you a Gulf South Conference matchup between your Valdosta State Blazers and the University of West Alabama Tigers.
A close eye on that and see how that one turns out. At number three is Hardin State, and currently VSU and West Alabama are tied for the fifth place, but the winner of today's contest will move up to be tied for either fourth or third place, depending upon the outcome of the Wichita Delta State game. Back to you, Mike.
That's great news, Trey. Great to know after a rough start, we still have a good heads-up perspective as to winning the conference. Right now, I believe you talked to Kellen Lewis earlier in the week.
Yeah, I spoke with Lewis to see if there were any areas of his game he decided to focus on since arriving here at VSU. And he also told me what he plans to do as far as game plan against West Alabama's defense.
Yeah, I think I tried to focus a little bit more on my passing game, my throwing accuracy. Might have to get a little bit back to the base, maybe run a little bit more to, make teams feel threatened. Looking at film a little bit, I realized a lot of teams think I'm just going to scramble out and throw the ball and not run it. So I'm looking to maybe switch it up a little bit this week.
Lewis has gotten off to a quick start this season. After just three games, he has racked up 628 yards through the air, and Coach Dean likes what he sees, and he only expects his quarterback to get better as the season progresses.
Well, it's good. I think Kellen's played very well for us. He's still trying to learn all of our players, and I think he's only going to get better and better and better as the season goes on, but I've been very pleased with him. He does a great job of leading our football team. And he makes very good decisions for us on the field.
The last time the Blazers started the season 1-2 was 1997. The Blazers missed the playoffs that year, but Coach Dean said, "We're not panicked. We control our own destiny. Our three goals are to win the conference, make the playoffs, and win the national championship. Right now, those three goals are still in sight."
Those are great goals and a really good heads-up attitude by Coach Dean. Let's take a look at our starting lineup, starting with our offense. Starting at X receiver from Waycross, All-American Cedric Jones. Opposite Jones is wide is freshman Gerald Ford. Z receiver hailing from Suwannee is senior R.J. Bastone. Fresno City College transfer Jesus Torres starts at left tackle. At left guard is junior Jamarian Brown. Starting center is senior Edward Gregory. Right guard from Madison, Florida, junior Kyle Fox will be starting. Hailing from Tifton is right guard Britt Wilson. At H receiver, senior from Miami, Florida, Cedric Evans. Starting at quarterback, Indiana transfer and Jacksonville native, number 15, Kellen Lewis. Starting at runner back, an Albany native and Blazer co-captain, number 3, Ronnie Nelson. And rounding out your offense is number 30, running fullback, senior Gabe Mold.
On the defensive side of the ball, we have Kier Moore starting at defensive end. True freshman Demetrius Bozeman at defensive tackle. Filling in for Demario Jones at nose tackle, number 56, Josh Stevens. At the other defensive end position, senior Melvin Black. Team co-captain Larry Dean at outside linebacker. The man at middle linebacker is DeMarcus Flanagan. Number 44, Ratu Rebella will be playing opposite of Larry Dean at outside linebacker. Rashad Etheridge will see action at the right cornerback position. Starting at free safety, number 26, Matt Pierce. Senior Josh Wiley at strong safety, and number 24, Carlos Anderson at the left cornerback.
On special teams, we have number 89 as our place kicker, true freshman Daniel Anderson. At punter, a sophomore from Waycross, Jack Fulford. Returning punts today will be number nine, Owen Dixon. And finally, returning kicks today is sophomore number 16, Isaiah Jupiter. Thank you for joining us here on VSU-TV. We're going to take a quick break and come back to you with the kickoff.
Valdosta, more than you know. A place where kids dream and kind hearts prevail. In a setting full of recreation and excitement for all ages. A city of vibrant growth, career opportunities, and a thriving business environment. Combined with progressive thinking, it's about exploring your future. Valdosta, Georgia, more than you know.
Welcome back to Bazemore-Hyder Stadium. I'm Mike Slater. Sitting next to me is Trey Williams. Blazers lost the coin flip. UWA has deferred. So luckily, VSU will get the kickoff.
I'm feeling the all-black units by the Blazers tonight, Mike.
Absolutely. Good reminiscent of the Black Swan. Kickoff, ball is high. Isaiah Jupiter comes in front and fields it. No, that's Ronnie Nelson.
And he's still
at
running.
At the 30. Nice return by Ronnie Nelson there on the kick coverage. Really good field position for the Blazers at about the 31-yard line. As you see on this replay, Ronnie Nelson, oh, nice cut right up the field, drilled by a bunch of people, ending what appeared to be a really good kickoff return. Offense taking the field, Kellen Lewis setting up behind center. Got Gerald Ford and Sed Jones on the near side. Ronnie Nelson in the backfield. Hiked the ball, Kellen Lewis to Jones. A 35 at the 40, taken out of bounds. Good, good pass. Nice little screenplay.
And it was about a yard shy on that play right there. And when I had my interview with Sed Jones the other day, he told me his favorite plays were when they set him up with the screens. And as you can see right there, he showed you why they're his favorite.
Great play, almost first down, first play, really good. Kellen Lewis back under center. Again, Gerald Ford and R.J. Bastone looks like wide up. Kellen receives the hike, passes out to Jones. Great catch, but misses it as he drops it as he is hit. Good play by number 19.
That's just a case where Cedric Jones knew the defender was coming in fast, and he tried to catch the ball and look for the defender at the same time and wasn't able to haul it in.
That was Chantrell Ford on the tackle there, knocking the ball out of Jones' hands. Back to center, R.J. Bastone lined up on the near side, Jones on the far side. Handoff to Ronnie Nelson up the middle. Nice cutback, gain of about 2 or 3 yards to the 43-yard line.
And that's what you like to see from your starting tailback right there, making a couple moves to get the first down. You know where the market was, and he did just enough to get there.
Blazer offense lines up again with R.J. Bastone on the near side. Kellen Lewis takes the height, looking for a receiver. Quick shovel pass to Ronnie Nelson, up past the 50 to the 45 into UWA territory.
And that was a nicely drawn up play there by the Blazers. You don't really see them do the shovel pass too often, but when they do, it catches most defenses off guard. As you can see right here, Kellen backs up, sees Ronnie Nelson up in the middle of the field, hands it to him. Ronnie Nelson takes what he sees, plenty of daylight up the middle of the field, and gets just around the 45-yard line.
Lewis lined up high, quick pass to Bastone at the 40. Bastone cuts back, stops, and is taken down right. Oh, ball is loose. Do not know if the fumble is it was a fumble. No, it not a fumble. Ball came out. Ball was out of bounds before the opposing team, the Tigers, got a hold of it. Lucky break for the Blazers.
It kind of looked like he was down on the play before the ball came out anyway, though. So, yeah, they're going to call it a fumble, but they're going to bring it back. I guess you can't progress the ball on a fumble out of bounds.
14:03 here in the first quarter. Second and short for the Blazers. Kellen Lewis lined up again behind center. Sed Evans and R.J. Bastone on the near side. Pass to Evans. Nice blocking up to the 30-yard line. Roughly, it looks like a rough gain of actually, that would be a first down.
Once again, just enough for the first down. The Blazers are taking what the defense is giving, and the defense is playing back. And that's leaving the Blazers plenty of time to get the screen set up. See Kellen Lewis hit Cedric Evans right here, who just follows his blockers and makes the play and heads upfield to try to make the play.
Blazers have been running what appears to be the hurry-up offense so far on this drive. Ronnie Nelson line up in the backfield. Gerald Ford, R.J. Bastone on the near side. Evans and Jones on the far side. Kellen with the hike, looking to Jones. Jones with the catch, makes a turnaround. He's at the 20. Dragging the defender down at the 13. Good pickup, good enough for a first down. Blazers are really on a roll so far in this opening drive.
And this is how I like to see the Valdosta State Blazers play. As you can see here, Kellen Lewis dropping back, finds his man, Cedric Jones, out wide open, one man on him. And he pretty much knows that Cedric Jones, when he's by himself, he can make a couple men miss as well as drag a couple along with him because he's just that strong.
Blazers, Kellen Lewis on a rollout, fires to the end zone to R.J. Bastone, pass broken up. Very lucky break for Kellen Lewis. Very close to an interception.
By number 29, Brandon Tisdale was able to get in there and break up the play.
Cedric Jones so far, 2 receptions of 26 yards. One more reception, and he will be moving up in the VSU record book. 13-20 here, left in the first quarter. Kellen Lewis looking, fires to R.J. Bastone. He's almost in the end zone, but brought down at the 3-yard line. Almost good enough for a first down, it looks like.
And when the Blazers come out and they play with a sense of urgency immediately at the beginning of the game, they tend to get pretty good results, as you can see here on this drive.
And it is a first down. Blazers are first and goal on their own 4-yard line. I wonder if we're going to see a running play here, possibly trying to bust it right up the center with Ronnie Nelson.
Yeah, I expect to see Nelson get it up the middle.
We have Gerald Ford and Sed Jones on the far side. Pass to Ronnie Nelson right up the middle, and Ronnie is in. Touchdown, Blazers.
There's the hand signal from the refs.
First score for the Blazers, opening drive right down the field.
Once again, Ronnie Nelson taking it right up the middle and able to get just enough to get into the end zone to break the plane. And the Blazers setting up for the extra point now. Number 89, Daniel Anderson, ready to kick off.
3-yard touchdown carry by Ronnie Nelson. Kick is up and kick is good. 7-0 lead by the Blazers. 12:45 left here in the first half. That was possibly one of the best opening drives I've seen the Blazers put together this year, Trey.
Yes, it was. It only took them 2 minutes and 15 seconds to actually get downfield and get the score, which is a trend that I've noticed from the Blazers so far this year. Majority of the times when they have the ball and they're able to get downfield very quickly, they tend to put up numbers. And when it takes the Blazers more than 5 minutes to get a score, usually they come away with a field goal instead of the touchdown.
I know there had been speculations of Sed Jones not getting a lot of playing time due to his absence last week's game. Obviously, that is not the case. 2 passes already to him. It looks like he's already all over the field and wide open.
Coach David Deans knows that he wants to come away with the win here today at Bazemore-Hyder Stadium. He has to get the ball in the hands of his best playmakers, and one of those playmakers being Cedric Jones.
Tigers are getting onto the field here, about to receive the kick from the Blazers. Daniel Anderson out to kick it off to the Tigers. Again, 12:45 left here in the first quarter, 7-0 Blazers.
We have number 7, Terry Allen, back to receive. And you have to be careful about Terry Allen here, Mike, because Terry Allen is one of the main returners here in the GSC. West Alabama is number 4 on special teams as far as returns goes, but good thing is the Blazers are number 4 when it comes to special team coverages on the kickoff, so let's see how this one turns out for the Blazers.
I have to correct myself. Daniel Anderson is not kicking it off. It is Justin Kramer, backup kicker. Very low squib kick. Bounces at the 20. UWA fields it at the 5. Running up is Allen. Nasty cut, but Blazers pile on at the 25-yard line. It looks like that's all he's going to get.
He was able to get away from number 21, Rashard Etheridge, right there on the return. It looks like Etheridge was sitting there waiting for him to come right into his arms. But once again, where the Blazers have been struggling when it comes to wrapping a man up in the open field. Let's hope the Blazers are able to get this together before this game goes on, or Deion Williams might be able to put together a couple passing yards through the air.
So UWA coming on the field, the Tigers, Deion Williams setting up behind center. Blazer defense taking the form. Like you said, Trey, earlier, you got to love the black uniforms. Deion Williams looking around for his man, receives the ball, pass to number 6 over his head, thrown away, incomplete. 2nd and 10 now for the Tigers. Jared Warsher was the intended receiver on that, but Williams just looked like he put a little bit too much into it.
And if you're the coaches on the West Alabama side of the ball, you do not want to see your star quarterback coming out and he's just eyeballing his main receiver the entire time. As soon as he received the snap, he looked at Warsham the entire time, going ahead and letting Carlos Anderson know that this is the man I'm throwing to.
Tigers back lined up. Deion Williams under center. Oh, he keeps on the play running forward. That is number
9.
Damian Baylor.
Damian Baylor is the top rusher on the West Alabama side of the football. It's Damian Baylor and Terry Allen. Terry Allen is an all-purpose kind of guy. He's a wide receiver, halfback, and special team. So I'm going to call him Mr. All-Purpose today.
3rd and 5 for the Tigers on their own 31. 12:05 left to play in the first quarter. Blazers up 7-0. Terry Allen lined up on the far side. Low snap. Deion Williams is pressured. Pocket collapse. Nice tip. Oh, interception by number 24, Carlos Anderson. Amazing play.
Once again, I seen Deion Williams doing what I said he did the first time. He was staring down his receiver, and then he dropped back after he had a little pressure. As you can see here, number 97, Melvin Black, got in to get the pressure on him, and he just threw the ball away. And that's where it got tipped by number looked like it might. Yeah, number 44, Ratura Bell, and it was able to come. Carlos Anderson was able to come up with the interception.
Carlos Anderson making that interception. Had a little insider information. Deion Williams apparently talked to Mr. Carlos Anderson, made him a phone call. A little trash talk going on there. Looks like Carlos is stepping up his game, though, and taking that trash talking very well. Already an interception. That would be VSU's third interception, or second, I believe. Second interception on the year.
Yeah, the first interception came from Rashard Etheridge.
Blazers on the field again. Kellen Lewis lining up. RJ Bastone and Gerald Ford on the near side. Both Cedrics, Jones and Evans, on the far side. Kellen receives the snap. Looks to Jones, pressured, running up the middle. Still on his feet. Cannot be tackled and is finally broken, brought down at the 10-yard line. Penalty flag in the backfield, though. It is against the Blazers. Looks like it is offensive holding.
No, it looked like it might have been a false start here on Cedric Evans. Kellen Lewis was hyped just before Kellen Lewis hiked the ball. Cedric Evans got a quick start downfield to try to, I guess, throw the defense off a little bit, and Kellen Lewis was able to take advantage of the open field and make a big run. No, actually, it was a holding call. You were right there, Mike.
Either way, that was a huge loss for the Blazers. That erased almost a 30-yard play by Kellen Lewis. Blazers now backed up all the way to the 46-yard line. They still are in UWA territory, though. It'll be first and 20 as the Blazers line up. Kellen Lewis walking up to call maybe an audible. No, he's just pointing out some defense. Again, we have RJ Bastone and Gerald Ford line up on the near side. Ronnie Nelt, nope. Who was that?
Gerald Ford and RJ Bastone.
David Arnold in the backfield. Jones, great catch at the 40, immediately brought down. That'll be a gain of about 8 for the Blazers.
That's his third catch already tonight here, Mike.
He's very close. If he has not already moved up in the record books, he will be doing it very, very soon. Great games for Jones so far.
Blazers, well, say Kellen Lewis is a man of his word. He already told me in the interview that I had with him earlier this week that he was going to try to run the ball a little bit more.
The running game is working out perfectly. Kellen Lewis back behind center, 10:45 left in the first. Blazers 7-0. Ball on the 39-yard line. Kellen back to pass, looking. Pump fakes, he is now out of the pocket, rolling to his right. He keeps on rolling, stops, goes forward, passes the line of scrimmage for a first down and a gain of about 6 or 7 out at the Blazer, or at the UWA 32-yard line.
Gain of about 5 yards on the carry. Blazers have a good way to go before it was a first down there, Mike. It's 8 left to go now in order to get the first down.
Blazers a little bit past their starting point at this current drive. Kellen Lewis again reading the defense. Hopefully he's finding a weak spot to exploit. We got RJ Bastone and Gerald Ford still on this side, and both Cedrics on the far side, and Ronnie Nelson in the backfield. Snap the ball. Kellen Lewis looking around for a receiver. Pocket breaks down. Pass. Oh, a little bit too low for Cedric Jones. And that was an incomplete. It will be fourth down and 8. 10 minutes left to go in the first. Blazers still up 7-0. Blazers bringing out their punter, Jack Fulford, to make a punt. Hopefully he can get them down into the. Hopefully he can get it down, pin the Tigers deep in their own territory, and let the Black Swarm take care of the rest. High punt, short, and no one's there to catch it. Blazers stop it, fall on it at the 11-yard line. Failed drive for the Blazers, but not everything's bad. Blazers still up 7-0 here, 9:49 left in the first quarter.
Some people might be wondering why the Blazers didn't take a field goal on that attempt instead of punting the ball off, but I'm pretty sure the Blazers defensive coaches are thinking that, well, the West Alabama offense wasn't able to move the ball against our defense, so hopefully we'll be able to do the same thing here on this drive and have pretty good field position.
Blazers taking on, getting on the field as the defense. Tigers lining up on their 10-yard line to begin their drive. Deion Williams in the backfield, waiting on the ball. Tony Allen on the far side. Play call dead, flags on the field, possible false start. Penalties, big, big problem for the Blazers so far this season. False start against the Tigers on number 56. Jared Porter backs up the Tigers half the distance to the goal. They're now on their own 4-yard line, it appears. No, they're on their own 6-yard line.
That's been the main problem with both teams here this year. They have problems with penalties on the offensive side of the ball.
A lot of green field in front of the Tigers. Hopefully our secondary can make sure that they don't get through that field. Tigers lining up. Deion Anderson pass, or no, a handoff to number 9. There is a fumble on the play recovered by the Tigers. That'll be second and 15 for the Tigers on their own 6-yard line.
For a minute, it looked like Damian Bailey was going to be able to pick up pretty good yardage right up the middle, but they didn't hand the ball off to him, and they tried to go with a pitch in the backfield instead, but somehow it must have been a miscommunication between Deion Williams and Worsham in the backfield.
Well, hopefully the Blazers can exploit these miscommunications that the Tigers are having. Blazers line up in the D. Deion Williams hiking the ball in his own end zone. Low snap, fall, pass almost picked off, deflected by number 21.
Rashad Etheridge.
Rashad Etheridge, flag on the play.
Etheridge saw the play and just got there just a little too early. As you can see here, Deion Williams finds his man, tried to set up the screen, but Rashad Etheridge took him out before the ball could even get there.
It looks like that's going to be a personal foul penalty on Etheridge. Player down on the field. We have 9:05 left in the first quarter, 7-0 Blazers. No flag on the play, legal hit. Tigers player still on the field, cannot get a read on his number on who that is, but.
Another lucky break on the side of the Blazers. And that was number 7,
right.
Terrell Allen, one of the big playmakers on the West Alabama offensive side of the ball. But now this gives the Blazers a pretty good opportunity to get good field position if the West Alabama team decides to punt this here, and hopefully they will.
Terry Allen being one of the big offensive leaders for this UWA Tigers offense. With him walking to the sidelines, don't know if he'll be out for a couple series or whatnot, but either way, he's not in the game right now. Blazers really need to exploit this. Tigers still lined up on their own 3-yard line, 3rd and 18, 9:05 left here at Bazemore-Hyder Stadium. Deion Williams signaling for motion, ball is hiked, rolls way back into his end zone, caught by numbers, overthrew his receiver into the sidelines. That would be 4th down for the Tigers, and here comes the punt team.
And as you can see, Deion Williams was very uncomfortable standing inside his own end zone trying to find an open wide receiver downfield, which is probably the reason why he overthrew Gerald Worsham on the outside, which would probably have been a pretty good pickup to put him in a better field position to punt the ball from.
Earlier today, we were talking about how the Blazers needed to put pressure on Deion Williams, and it looks like they're succeeding so far. He's, like you said, very uncomfortable in the pocket, and his throws are less than accurate. Punt by the Tigers bounces at their own 40-yard line, caught by Chris Wellborn. And he is down at the UWA 30-yard line. Blazers coming back on the field after having to punt last drive and his opening drive's touchdown. They have great field position. You couldn't ask for anything better than being in your own goal line.
As long as the Blazers don't do what they've had a habit of doing, which is getting silly penalties that push them back when they have pretty good field position to score.
Holding call during the kick. Holding call on the Blazers. Very bad. Backs them up. It is now first and 20 for the Blazers as they start. Ball moved all the way. No, I'm sorry. It'll be first and 10. The ball was just moved all the way back to the 46-yard line. Still in Tigers territory, though.
Blazers will take over first and 10.
Once again, the Blazers are notorious for this. The last game in the loss against Wachita Baptist, the Blazers had 108 yards worth of penalties.
Kellen Lewis receives a snap, pass to Cedric Jones, running up the sideline, breaking tackles, finally brought down at the 38-yard line. Gain of about 4 on the play.
And it looks like the offensive coordinator is trying to give Cedric Jones some plays that he feels more comfortable running so that hopefully he can make a big play and make something happen for the Blazers here tonight.
Earlier this week, you had a chance to interview him, and he said he loved the screen pass. Looks like that's what they're trying to give it to him. Blazers lining up. Kellen Lewis receives the handoff, handoff to number three, Ronnie Nelson, right up the middle. Maybe a yard gain, but the flag on the play.
Number three, Ronnie Nelson, the ball carrier.
8:19 left here in the first quarter. Still 7-0 Blazers. Looks like it will be against the Blazers as they're moving them back. Offensive holding on number seven, Josh Wiley.
Can't be number seven. Number seven, Josh Wiley, is a safety. Why would we have a safety out there? Got it. I'm going to say it must have been number seven, Edmund Kabila.
Anyway, Blazers move back into their own territory at their 49-yard line. Wyatt set up in the spread. Kellen Lewis, oh, pocket broken down. Little shovel pass to Ronnie Nelson, and he is brought down in the backfield by a whole gang of Tigers. Negative yardage on that play.
Either that was a design play to try to make the defense think that they had Kellen Lewis in the backfield and set the little screen up for Ronnie Nelson, or just a broken down offensive line.
Looked like the latter of that. Kellen was already off and running as soon as he got the ball because he had a defender right in his face. Second and 10 for the Blazers on their third and 17 on the 47-yard line. Handoff to Ronnie Nelson up the gut and back to the 49-yard line where they're about to their original starting position on this drive. Yeah. It's now fourth down with 13 yards to go. Bringing on the punt team. Jack Fulford will be punting off again.
And once again, as you can see, the penalties coming into play here against the Blazers. They had pretty good field position. Possibly able to go downfield and do what they did on the very first series, but simple mistakes pushed them back out of range, and now they have to punt.
Punt really high. UWA defender there to catch it. Catches it on the 3-yard line. Blazers automatically there. Wrap him up at the 3-yard line. That's where the Tigers will start this number next six, drive deep into their own territory.
And that was number six, Gerald Worsham. You don't usually see him making plays like that. Besides him and Terry Allen, they're the top two returners on the West Alabama's off of special teams. And I think he'd usually make a better play than that, knowing that he's within inside the 10-yard line to just let the ball go and bounce in the end zone to take it out to the 20. But once again, he just helped the Blazers out.
Hopefully being this far backed up into their own end zone, let the Blazers put a little bit of a pass rush and maybe even pull out a safety in this thing. We'll see. It's a black swarm, and they're possible for anything.
Yeah, from the way the Blazers defense is playing tonight, anything is possible, Mike.
6:47 left here at Bazemore-Hyder Stadium in the first, 7-0. Blazers on defense. Deion Williams receives the ball, rolls out to his right, pass to number nine, way over his head, overthrew his receiver, Damian Baylor.
Williams passes it incomplete, intended for number eight, Randy Lowry.
That was actually number eight, Randy Lowry, who went out for the pass. And once again, Lewis being pressured and just got rid of the ball.
It's second and 10, ball on the four for the UWA Tigers. 6:14 left in the first quarter. A lot of passing so far from the Tigers game. Not too much of their run yet, but I guess you could attribute that to a very good run defense so far.
I'd expect them to run the ball right so deep into their own territory, but I guess not.
Finally, a handoff, and the Blazers stop him and bring him down. Flag on the play, though. Possible safety. We'll have to see after the ruling on the field with the penalty.
And that was number 27, Donald Maxwell, in there to break up the play.
That was a great play. Blazers immediately in the backfield. As we see with the replay, 23 going down, desperately trying to get out. If this flag doesn't offset it, that's a definite safety. But it looks like it might.
Roosevelt Ross had nowhere to go on that run.
Illegal formation on the Tigers. Penalty is declined. Third down on the one. Third down on the one for the Tigers. Things not working out at all for the Tigers so far in this drive. They keep getting pushed back even farther, and they only started on the 4-yard line.
For the Tigers.
And now either there's some confusion on the field or maybe the Offense is still trying to get the play from the sideline to get set up.
Either way,
only 3 seconds on the play clock.
And the Tigers take a timeout to avoid the delay of game. Right here at the VSU-TV, it's 7-0 with 6:11 left in the first quarter. We'll be taking a quick break.
Hey, babe, you ready to go?
I'm really not up for it.
If a chronic illness is driving you apart, call 1-800-344-4867 because a healthy relationship matters.
Welcome back to VSU-TV. We're here at Bazemore-Hyder Stadium. VSU Blazers on top of the UWA Tigers, 7-0. It's 3rd and 13 for the Tigers on their own 1-yard line. Blazers have them pinned back extremely deep. All we can hope for is a safety and not for them to get this first down. Dale Williams with the ball thrown to number 9, and that is a first down. Nope, non-completion. That is not a completion. He dropped it. Number 9, Randy Lowry with that drop.
No, he actually came up with it.
He actually did come up with it. I saw a ref signaling incomplete. That's a first down completion of about 20 yards for Deion Williams. Biggest play of the night for the Tigers. Line back up on offense. Williams, oh, false start, it looks like, by the offensive line.
Well, this is what I expect to see from the West Alabama offense anyway. We both know that Deion Williams is a prolific passer. He's already has almost 1,000 yards on the season coming into this game, so I expect them to try to spread the field and try to open up the run game a little bit as well.
And with that pass to Randy Lowry, he now has over 1,000 yards on the season. Very impressive to be the fourth game of the season. Or fifth game for them, sorry. Again, 5:40 left in the first quarter. Blazers on defense. Deion Williams with the ball passes way over number 15, Jason Hawkins, their tight end, way over his head, almost picked off by one of the Blazers' safeties. Deion Williams just looks like he's hurling all of his throws, not even really getting the chance to settle into the pocket. Blazers in the backfield on almost every play, pressuring Deion Williams. It's a good thing, though. Glad to see the defense got this lively spirit.
And this is what the VSU defense is known for, Mike.
2nd and 15, ball on the 17-yard line for the Tigers. Deion Williams hands it off to Damian Baylor, tackled with a gain of 1 or 2. Flag on the play, though. Looks like it is holding on the Tigers. UWA seems to be having the same problem VSU does with a lot of penalties so far in this game. Blaze FM 90.9 on your radio dial is back in the air. That means that Skip Gildersleeve has returned with Lest We Forget, a celebration of college radio's past, every Sunday night at 9 p.m. on WVVS. Like I said, Tigers struggling with penalties just like the Blazers.
Both of these teams are known for their penalties, like I've told you, Mike.
Five penalties so far total.
The Blazers are on the good side, on the right side of the penalties tonight for the Blazer Nation fans. It works out.
Absolutely. Hopefully we can put some more pressure on Deion Williams like we've been doing so far, maybe come up with another interception or, even better yet, a fumble. Williams hikes the ball, rolls back into his own end zone. Pressure by 84, pass complete to number 15, Jason Hawkins, their tight end. Gain of about 6 or 7, it looks, very minimal gain on this play. Deion Williams just had to get rid of it. He was about to be hit by number 94, Demetrius Bozeman. Bozeman was in Deion Williams' face almost immediately when the ball was hiked, so close to a safety for the Blazers' Black Swarm defense. 3rd and 17, ball on the 15 for the Tigers. Larry Dean trying to get the crowd pumping. Williams slips as he throws and over, and it goes right through the hands of number 3, Michael Townsend, senior from Fort Mississippi.
Even if he had made that catch, they still wouldn't have been able to get the first down off of it.
So the Blazers force a 3-and-out, very long 3-and-out. at least two or three penalties in that whole series. It's now fourth and 17, ball on the 15. We have Chris Wellborn back to receive the punt by the Tigers. Tyler Kimbrough gets the snap, kicks it off. Oh, and it's blocked by number 21. Rashad Etheridge does not follow on it, though. Blazers do have it. They recover. Blazers recover on their own or on the Tigers' 3-yard line. Blazers will have be having first and goal when they get on the field.
And Rashad Etheridge making a heads-up play for the Blazers. He was able to get through the line and block the punt and then was able to get back into the play and able to come up with the ball.
Great penetration by the defense so far. Very reminiscent of the Black Swarm. Glad to see the defense starting to click, getting their composure, and starting to trust everybody. And they're just making really great heads-up plays.
And even though we had a little bit of rain right here before the beginning of the game, looks like the crowd slowly starting to fill up the Blazers side of the stadium here, Mike.
Kellen Lewis in the pocket, ready to receive the snap. Cedric Jones out to the right. Oh, Lewis keeps it, rolls to the left, into the end zone. Touchdown, Blazers. 13-0 now with that touchdown. 4:35 left in the first quarter. That was a great cutback by Lewis. As you see on the replay, finds the hole, gets right into the end zone. Gotta love having a mobile quarterback. Gotta love it.
That big block by David Arnold, he was able to get to the daylight that he needed to get into the end zone.
Jack Fulford back to make the extra point attempt for VSU. Ball is hiked, kick is up, and it is good. 14-0 Blazers lead with 4:35 left in the fourth. Vote 2009, a local political forum will air during the month of October, beginning on October 4th at noon. Get informed with Vote 2009, local political debates only on VSU-TV.
So far, I'm pretty sure that the Blazer Nation is loving what they're seeing from their Valdosta State Blazers. So far, they have put together two drives that were able to get them in the end zone and have them up 14-0 with 4 minutes and 35 seconds to go here in the first half.
Cullen Lewis, 9-for-12 with 73 yards, longest play 18 yards. Great day so far for the Blazers. Defense stepping up, offense is absolutely clicking, and it just doesn't seem like the Tigers can keep up with our wide receivers, leaving a lot of holes for them.
And thanks to the great field position from West Alabama, it only took the Blazers 4 seconds to take that in for a touchdown. The main thing for the Blazers when they have the ball on offense, it depends on how long the Blazers have the ball, which usually determines if they're able to put up for a touchdown or a field goal.
Blazers on the field to kick off to the Tigers. Number 81, Justin Kramer is the kicker. Hopefully get a little bit higher and more power into his kick than last time. Kicked a little squibber to start the game off.
We also have number 7, Terry Allen, back in return.
Kick to the 5-yard line. Terry Allen is returning up the sideline, and he is stopped by a swarm of Blazers at their own 24-yard line. It's 4:30 left here in the first quarter. 14-0 is the score. Blazers on top.
Number 7, Terry Allen is the return man for the Tigers.
Blazer defense back on the field. Tigers coming out for first and 10, ball on their own 30-yard line. So far, I don't even think the Tigers have gotten into Valdosta State territory yet.
From all the game film that I've seen on the West Alabama Tigers, the one thing that I've noticed is that they're not really a first quarter team. They usually put up majority of their points in the second and fourth quarter. So we still have a little while before we see what the Tigers are actually made of.
Just as long as the defensive line can keep putting pressure on Williams, I think we'll be pretty good for this game. Blazer D set up. Deion Williams back to receive the snap off. And whistle's blown, flags go in the air. Looks like a false start. Possibly on us.
Delay of game. Offense.
Delay of game by the Tigers, moving them back 5 yards. Obvious confusion on the field for the Tigers.
It just looks as if they're not very comfortable here in Bazemore-Hyder Stadium. Maybe the Blazer Nation are making just a little bit too much noise for the Tigers out here on the field.
Again, 4:30 left here in the first. 14-0 Blazers. First and 15 for the Tigers on their own 20-yard line. Deion Anderson back to receive the snap. Calls for it. Low snap. Pass off the hands of number 8, Randy Lowry. Almost picked up by one of our safeties. Just a little bit too short to get that. Great coverage by our quarterback so far. I haven't really seen anybody get open except for that one 20-yard pass that Anderson had to get out of the backfield, out of his own end zone last drive. Deion Williams ready to receive the snap, passes, hands it off. No, he keeps it running to the right, immediately tackled, brought down in the backfield by number 50. Kier Moore, great tackle, great penetration. Black Swarm is in full effect tonight.
And I'm pretty sure defensive coordinator Joe Cawthon is loving what he's seeing out here from this Blazer defense. I'm pretty sure he ran them pretty hard in drills during practice to make sure that they were able to stop the run and that the cornerbacks got back to the bases when it came down to making sure that the wide receivers weren't able to get open on those routes.
Great numbers so far for the Blazers defense. Only 4 yards allowed on the ground, 27 in the air. Larry Dean getting the crowd going. Blazer Nation on its feet. Deion Williams receives the snap. Long pass to number 8, and it's way over his head. Diving catch. Randy Lowry on that play misses it. Great coverage by our cornerbacks. He was double teamed the entire way.
Randy Lowry. That brings up fourth down.
And this is something out of the ordinary for Deion Williams. He has a 153 rating of efficiency coming into this game tonight, but tonight he's looked very lackluster.
Fourth and 15 means the Tigers will punt. Number 80, Chris Wellborn, back to receive the kick. As Tyler Kimbrough sets up to receive the kick and punt it to the Blazers. Punt is high, very short. Caught at the 37-yard line. Gain of maybe 1. Brought down hard. No return on that play. Catch the David Dean Show on VSU-TV every morning at 9 p.m. and 11 p.m. Check TV guide listings for other airings of the David Dean Show here on VSU-TV. Blazer offense taking the field. Haven't seen them look this comfortable. Haven't seen them look this comfortable in a while. Really got a good chemistry going with their offense. Kellen Lewis receives the snap. Pass to Cedric Jones. Catches it. Fourth down, flag on the play. Possible defensive pass interference. The quarterback was all over said as soon as he caught it and even before.
As you can see here, Kellen Lewis drops back and finds Cedric Jones, but it looks like number 10, Eric Hendrick got there just before the football did and caused some contact. Let's see what the call is down on the field.
Holding on the defense, number 19, Chantrell Ford. It is declined, and the Blazers get a first down out of Sed Jones. Really tough catch. Just shows how physical Sed Jones is. Not letting the defender wrestle the ball from him as he's going to the ground. Kellen Lewis lines up again. Ronnie Nelson actually lined up to receive. But no, Ronnie Nelson receives the handoff up the middle, gain of about 3 yards. 3 minutes left here at Bazemore-Hyder Stadium, 14-0 Blazers. Second and 6 for the Blazers on the 50-yard line. Kellen Lewis receives the snap, pass directly to number 16, Isaiah Jupiter, gain of about 4 yards on the play. He's brought down at the 45-yard line.
And West Alabama is giving the Valdosta State wide receivers a lot of cushion along the outsides. That's why Kellen Lewis has been able to set up the screens for Cedric Jones and then hit Cedric Jones in stride, as you've seen on a couple plays ago. But so far, it looks as if they don't have any answers for these Blazers wide receivers out here.
Blazers making a few offensive switches. Gerald Ford and Owen Dixon going to the sidelines. Blazers in the huddle on the 50, ball on the 45-yard line. Third and 1 for the Blazers. Almost 2 minutes left in the fourth quarter. 14-0 Blazers.
Timeout. Valdosta.
Timeout Valdosta. Timeout Valdosta here. 2 minutes left in the first quarter, 14-0. Valdosta State, we're going to take a quick break here on VSU-TV.
Filing for Social Security online is so easy, a beatnik can do it with his laptop in any malt shop.
Welcome back to Bazemore-Hyder Stadium, home of your Valdosta State Blazers on VSU-TV. I'm Mike Slater. Next to me, Trey Williams. Blazers commanding lead, 14-0, 2 minutes left here in the first quarter. Blazers coming out in the field, third down and one to go on the Tigers' 45-yard line. Big conference about this play. Had a conference on the field and call a timeout. They're still back in the huddle as the play clock has not started yet. Blazers lining up in what appears to be an I formation. Ronnie Nelson in the far backfield with David Arnold in front of him. Kellen Lewis talking to his running backs. Movement by David Arnold. It's a hike and it's a quarterback sneak. Kellen Lewis going forward. Oh, tackled and brought back down. Does not look like he got the first down. Very, very short to it. Quarterback sneak might or might not have worked out.
Blazers first down.
And it did. Blazers got the first down. First and 10 on the Tigers' 44-yard line. 2 minutes left here in the first quarter. 14-0 Blazers. Lewis in the backfield with Ronnie Nelson. No, with David Arnold, I'm sorry. Gerald Ford in motion. And again, pass to Cedric Jones, caught at the 40-yard line. Pickup of about five on the play.
And Ced Jones is having a career night. He only needed two catches to move up to the NCAA career list in receptions tonight. He already has six catches.
Second down and six. Gerald Ford and Owen Dixon on the near side. Flag thrown immediately as it is high. Caught by number 32, Larry. No. Caught by Cody Case. Flag on the field, though. Back at the line of scrimmage right before the 40-yard line. And it looks like it's coming back for the Blazers. That penalty erasing what appeared to be a 10 to 15-yard gain by Cody Case.
Yeah, that was a false start on behalf of the Blazers. I didn't hear who the penalty was actually on, but no, illegal formation.
Legal formation on the Blazers, 5 yard penalty backs them up to second and 11, I do believe, on the 45-yard line. So far, Blazers have had three penalties for accumulation of 25 yards. It's nothing like 108 yards last game, but it's getting close. Kellen Lewis receives a snap pass to number 9, Owen Dixon, and he drops it right to his hands. No pressure by a defender, just in the hands and right out of him.
He jumped straight into the air and put himself in position to come down with a completion, but just couldn't hang on to it. That would have been very helpful in gaining some of these yards back that the Blazers just lost on that penalty.
3-11, ball on the 45. Kellen Lewis in the backfield. Gerald Ford and Owen Dixon on the far side. Cody Case and Cedric Jones on the far side. A little confusion on the field, taking some direction from the coach as Kellen Lewis is looking over to the sideline. High ball, dead ball, foul. It's false start on number 72, Mesh Wakamadi. Redshirt freshman making a false start, bringing the Blazers back even more. It will now be 3rd and 16 for the Blazers. Penalties are killing us, Trey.
That is the 5th penalty on the Blazers here tonight, Mike. And if the Blazers can't cut out all these penalties, they might be put themselves in a position to let West Alabama get right back in this game.
1 minute left in the first quarter, 14-0 Blazers, 3rd and 16 on the 50-yard line. Kellen Lewis receives the snap, looking for a receiver, looking all over the field. No one is open. Finally, he's flushed out of the pocket, rolling to his left. Up to the 50, makes a pass to Cedric Jones, and he drops it right to his hands and right out. Again, no pressure by a cornerback on the receiver, just a drop pass.
And Cedric Jones, no, he let that one get away from him. It was right there in his hands, and he had the opportunity to make the big play. But I can tell you one thing that I saw on that play that I am absolutely loving to see from the freshman, Mesh Wakamadi. He was able to stand back there and give his quarterback the protection that he needed to keep his eyes downfield and try to make the big play.
Blazer set up to punt. Ball is punted high and deep, caught, nope, over the head. Dropped and jumped on by the Blazers at the Tigers' 1 yard line. Amazing punt.
Looked like then Gerald Warsham was going with that 10-yard rule, and just so happened it didn't work out for him. The ball took a Blazer bounce and stopped right inside the 5 yard line, and now the Blazers have the West Alabama Tigers pinned deep within their own territory once again.
The American Red Cross is looking for donors in the Valdosta area to set up and help with the blood shortages. Viruses such as H1N1 have contributed to growing shortages, and the Red Cross is in need of all blood types. To set up an appointment, call 1-800-GIVE-LIFE or go to www.givelife.org. Blazer defense back on the field. Deion Williams in his own territory, something he's become accustomed to this game. Handoff up the middle. Gain of about 3 yards on the play. That was number 9, Damian Baylor, on the carry. Second and 6, ball on the 24 for the Tigers. First quarter winding down, less than 15 seconds to go. Blazers still on top, 14-0. Williams trying to get in one last play before the end of the quarter. Don't think he's going to get it in. And he does, hikes the ball, handoff to number 9, up the middle, stopped almost immediately. Marginal gain at best.
That's the end of the first quarter, your score.
That was the end of the first quarter, your score, 14-0. Blazers on top.
Ladies and gentlemen, as a part of today's...
I thought indoor tanning was safe.
They said their tanning rays were less likely to cause a sunburn.
What you need to know is UV light from indoor tanning
can cause premature aging.
And even worse, UV light can increase your risk of skin cancer,
including melanoma, the deadliest form of skin cancer.
In fact, current estimates are that 1 in 5 Americans develop skin cancer.
One person dies from melanoma about every hour.
I don't want to be one of them.
This message brought to you by the American Academy of Dermatology.
Welcome back to Bazemore-Hyder Stadium, brought to you courtesy of VSU-TV. I am Mike Slater, standing next to me, Trey Williams. Blazer defense on the field. Deion Williams looking to make something happen for his UWA Tigers on this drive. Not much for him. 15 minutes, start of the second quarter here at Bazemore-Hyder. 14-0, Blazers on top. It's 3rd and 4, ball on the 26 for the Tigers. Man in motion, handoff to number 4. Up to the left side, trying to get through, finds nothing. Blazers everywhere. Flag on the field, though. As we await the officials calling on the field, it is against the Tigers. Looks like they will be moving their ball back even further into their own territory. Illegal formation on the Tigers. More than 4 men in the backfield. Penalty is declined, though. Fourth down to go. Tigers bringing out their punt team. So far, UWA has had 3 punts, averaging 26.3 yards. Number 80 back to receive for the Blazers, Chris Wellborn.
And this is what you'd like to see from your defense. The defense has been able to force a lot of 3-and-outs here already just at the beginning of the second half. And now the defense looks like they can be able to be well rested as the game goes on.
Kick is up and it is tipped, spiraling into the air, out of control, and it's stopped on the 42-yard line.
And it looked as if the ball might have touched one of the Blazers players, but Chris Wellborn was able to notice that one of his teammates accidentally touched the ball and was able to get in to get on top of it before the West Alabama team was able to take notice.
14:33 left in the first half here at Bazemore-Hyder Stadium. Blazer offense coming onto the field. First down and 10 on the 42-yard line. Blazers really have things going tonight. A lot of chemistry. And Colin Lewis in the backfield awaiting the snap. Gerald Ford and Isaiah Jupiter line up on the near side. Hand off to number 10, David Arnold, up to the left side. Breaks a few tackles and a run to the UWA Tigers 43-yard line. First down for the Blazers.
And as you can see here on the replay, David Arnold gets the ball, and he has plenty of daylight in front of him. And he just shakes off a tackler right there and keeps driving until he's brought down by number 19, Chantrell Ford.
Great run for the Blazers. Kellen Lewis still back there receiving the snaps. Again to Arnold, up the gut, breaks a few tackles. Rush for about 6 on the play.
And this is usually how the Blazers tend to wear down the opposing team's defense. They bring David Arnold out to pound and pound and pound and pound until the other team eventually wears down. And then they put Ronnie Nelson and Michael Brown in there to show them the speedy side of the Blazers halfbacks.
13:52 left in the quarter, 14-0 Blazers, 2nd and 5 on the Tigers, 37. Kellen with the ball, passed directly to R.J. Bastone, makes the catch up the field for a gain of about 15 or 16. Really good play for Kellen Lewis. Results in the first down for the Blazers, 1st and 10 on the Tigers' 24-yard line with 13:39 to play in that first half.
And that was a great block by number 30, Gabe Moser. Great. R.J. Bastone open to pick up some pretty good yardage. Usually don't see a fullback move that fast, but he was able to get to the outside, make the block for R.J., so he was able to pick up the yards.
13, and
we have a player down on the field right now.
Tiger player down on the field. 13:34 left in the first half, 14-0 Blazers. 1st and 10, ball on the 24. We're going to go to a quick break here on VSU-TV here at Bazemore-Hyder Stadium.
I joined the National Guard and never thought I'd be saving lives.
I put on the uniform and I have a whole new outlook on life.
Country, community, family. That's what matters most to me. If that matters to you, go to 1-800-GO-GUARD.com.
Welcome back to Bazemore-Hyder Stadium. Blazers up 14-0 with 13:34 left in the first half. 1st and 10 for the Blazers on the 24-yard line of the Tigers. Kellen Lewis been running about 2 or 3 back-to-back running plays, netting him a good couple first downs. Pat, handoff to number 2. Derek Harris, short run to the right side, gain of about 3 or 4 yards for the Blazers.
And you're seeing the Blazers game plan go into motion as they take David Arnold out of play and put Derek Harris in, which is one of their faster backs, to try to see if he can break something to the outside after hopefully the defense is a little gassed thanks to having to deal with David Arnold.
Derek Harris is a 5'8", 169 sophomore. Like you said, got a lot of speed. Kellen Lewis receives the snap, looking for a receiver. Floater to Gerald Ford. No, that was Isaiah Jupiter right off his fingertips as he makes a diving play. Incomplete. 2nd and 9. Ball in the 23 for the Blazers. 14-0. On top are your VSU Blazers.
And that was pretty good defense by Chantrell Ford there to make sure that number 16, Isaiah Jupiter, didn't get around to make the big play.
Derek Harris still in the backfield for the Blazers. Sed Jones comes on the field. Isaiah Jupiter out. Jones and Evans lining up on your near side. Gerald Ford and R.J. Bassone on the far side with Kellen Lewis. Receives the snap, rolling out to his right, fires to R.J. Bastone up the sideline, dragged out by a multitude of Tigers defenders. Gain of about 8 yards and a first down for the Blazers. 1st and 10 for the Blazers on the Tigers' 11-yard line with 12:30 left to play in this first half. Again, lining up, same formation, Jones and Evans on the near side. Lewis receives the snap, pass to Sed Jones, caught for a gain of 4 yards for the Blazers. First, second and four with 12-12 left in the first half. 14-0 Blazers.
And the first quarter was all Blazers, Mike. The Blazers racked up 112 yards of total offense, whereas West Alabama only had 31. On 27 passes for the West Alabama had on 27 passes and 4 rushing yards, and VSU had 92 passing yards and 20 rushing yards, completely outmatched as it seems.
David Arnold back in for the Blazers, possibly as a fullback to truck up the middle and get into that end zone for the Blazers. Kellen Lewis awaiting the snap, snap to him, rolling out, and a hard direct pass to number 19, Gerald Ford, broken up by a defender, but a flag on the play, and it looks like it's going to be defensive pass interference.
And that is the leading tackler in the GSC, Mr. J.D. Douglas, number 14 for the West Alabama Tigers.
Still awaiting the official call on the field.
Defense, number 14, half the distance to the goal, automatic.
Defensive pass interference, half the distance to the goal, second and five for the Blazers. Ball on the 6-14-0. Blazers on top, 11:38 left in the first half. David Arnold still in the game for the Blazers. Sed Evans on the near side. Trips on the far side, though. Possibly see a little shovel pass or a fade route into the end zone. Isaiah Jupiter in motion to the near side. Lewis receives the snap off. Immediate pressure forces the incomplete short pass to number one, Sed Evans. Player down on the field, 49 for the Tigers. That's Andre Woods.
This is very uncharacteristic to see the West Alabama defense playing this way. I know J.D. Douglas is a very big, well-known safety in the GSC. He leads the GSC coming into this game. He had 44 tackles, almost averaging 10 tackles a game. But so far tonight, it's been relatively quiet.
I'm sorry, that's Dwayne Perryman on the field, defensive lineman for the Tigers. So far, Lewis has been 12 for 18 in passing. Really good percentage with, I believe, one touchdown.
Two if you count the run.
Second and three for the Blazers. Ball in the third. Injured player still being tended to for the Tigers. Looking for more fun on campus? There will be a screamer slide set up in the Palms Quad on Monday, October 5th. The slide will be in the quad from 12 to 3 p.m. Bring a friend and try your hand at the always entertaining screamer slide. .11:34 left in the first half here. 14-0, Blazers on top. Second and three, ball on the third. Blazers in the red zone. And I believe we read earlier, Blazers have the top red zone offense in the GSC.
Yeah, coming into this game, they were 6-6 in the red zone. The Blazers are very productive whenever they are able to get down into the red zone area.
So far, we've seen a very productive side for the offense of VSU and not so much for UWA. Only one first down for the Tigers compared to 11 for VSU. 7 rushes for 5 yards for the Tigers in comparison to 10 rushes for 42 yards for VSU. Injured player getting up off the field. It's always a good sign to see someone get up and get off the field. Blazers are beating down on the Tigers with their plays. 8 plays for 32 yards for the Tigers, whereas VSU has 32 plays for 164 yards so far.
Mike, this is a very, very big game for the Blazers. They came into this game 1-2, tied for 5th place in the GSC. In order for the Blazers to put themselves back into a good position in order to get into the playoffs, they must win out and get a little help from some of the other GSC opponents as well.
Including Delta State, who's playing at Wichita Baptist tonight. Game time should be on right now. Blazers back on the field, 2nd and 3, ball in the third. They are in the red zone for the second time so far today. 14-0 is the score. Blazers on top, 11:34 left to play in the first half. Kellen Lewis with David Arnold in the backfield for him. Sed Evans lined up on the near side. trips on the right with Jupiter and Gerald. Oh, quarterback keep. Lewis to the end zone. Looks like his knee was down on the 1 yard line. It'll be third and inches for the Blazers.
And as you can see here, Kellen Lewis had plenty of space to make the run, but he was shoestring tough before he came down. He stretched out, but he wasn't able to make it.
I don't know if that play was originally designed for Kellen Lewis, but if not, it seemed to work out very well for the Blazers. Dogpaw on the line. It's the Blazers snap, and it's a possible fumble for the Blazers. Fumble is being ruled dead on the field, down by contact, no turnover. Blazers get a really lucky break in their end zone.
And that's what I expected from the Blazers offense, to try to run a quarterback sneak. Last time they ran the quarterback sneak here at home against Southern Arkansas, Kellen Lewis bobbled the snap a little bit, but was able to pick it back up and run it in for a score.
It's now fourth and one on the goal line. Literally, the ball is just inches from going into the goal line. Blazers look like they are going to go for it.
And I expect the Blazers to give the ball to that big bruiser, David Arnold, and let's see what he can do with it as far as getting into the end zone.
David Arnold and Josh Seibeck in the backfield looking to pound it through. Hand off to David Arnold. Keep by Kellen Lewis. Roll out to the left, and he is in. Touchdown, Blazers. 20-0 now for the Blazers with 10 minutes left here in the first half.
And that was a beautiful fake by the Blazers. I'm pretty sure that the West Alabama defense was thinking the exact same thing I was. If I see David Arnold in the backfield, I'm going to expect Kellen Lewis to come back and hand it off to him. But instead, he rolls out, sees he has lots of green in front of him, and decides to keep it himself and take it on in with number two, Tariq Ali, right behind him.
Blazers lineman for the kick, Daniel Anderson, is back in the game to kick for the Blazers and get this extra point to put them up 21-0. Snap, ball kicked through the uprights. It is good. VSU winning 21-0, 10 minutes, 7 seconds left in the first half.
The Blazers have came out and made a statement here tonight to let the West Alabama team know that they will not go lightly. They still have a chance to get into the playoffs, and they also have a chance to try to come out on top of the GSC, and they're going to make sure that they do everything within their power to do just that.
Great drive for the Blazers. They started off with really good field position and took advantage of it, driving down the field into the end zone with a really nice rollout run by quarterback number 15, Kellen Lewis. Time of possession completely lopsided in this game. Tigers with 6 minutes and 20 seconds compared to the Blazers whopping 13:33, almost doubling the Tigers' time of possession. Seems like a VSU Blazer game, if any.
And this is what Coach David Deans expect to see from his Blazers. Them getting out there and getting to that old-fashioned Dean football, putting up points on the board and making the other team try to catch them instead of the other way around.
It looks like a fire was really lit underneath the VSU Blazers after that loss last weekend. You can see the determination in their eyes, especially with a defense that just has not let up pressuring Deion Williams.
That's the one thing I can say about the Blazers defense. They tend to be suspect. From one minute, they're getting completely manhandled by the opposing team, and then the next week they come out and they want to put a statement in everybody's mind to let them know they are one of the dominant defenses in the GSC.
Justin Kramer doing the kickoff. It's low, kind of high, and a catch on the 5 yard line by Terry Allen, running up, and he's still going. Brought down finally by the VSU defenders at the Tigers' 30 yard line. Kick return of about 25 yards for the Tigers. They'll start first and 10 on their 30 with 9:59 left in the first half. Blazers up 21-0.
Looks like the Blazers might be getting a little frustrated with the fact that they're letting number 7, Terry Allen, bring the ball back so far when they're used to stopping the person on special teams after the game about close to 18 yards. But once again, that is Mr. All-Purpose Yards out there trying to put his team in pretty good field position to hopefully get back into this game.
VSU Blazers back out on defense. Williams lines up to receive and handoff to number 23, and he is up the middle, breaking a few tackles, a good rush for about 20. Roosevelt Ross on the carry there just broke through the middle of the VSU offensive or defensive line.
And that is the biggest play from the West Alabama offense all night. As you can see, they were able to make a very big hole for Russell Ross to run up through, and he was brought down by number 7, Josh Wiley, before he was able to break it off for the touchdown.
took the Tigers well over 20 minutes to get that first big play of the game. Williams again, hands off to 23. Roosevelt Ross up the gut again, stopped, met by a swarm of black jerseys and brought down possibly even behind the line. It's 9:23 left here in the first half. Blazers are up 21-0.
True freshman number 94, Demetrius Bozeman, is playing pretty tough out here on this against this West Alabama offense. He is one of the first tacklers in the backfield almost every play.
Williams directing traffic, receives the ball, looking for an open man, passes deep into the secondary. Pass broken up by number 7,
Josh Wiley,
making a big play on their star receiver, Terry Allen, right there, making him drop the ball and lose possession.
That was actually their big receiver, number 21, Terry Levi. He's 6'2", 225, and he was able to get matched up with little old Josh Wiley. He was only 6'1", 196. Well, I guess he's not too much bigger than Josh Wiley, but Josh Wiley was able to get in there and put the hit on him and make him drop the ball.
UWA Tigers have a 3rd and 9 with the ball on their 49-yard. They have completed only 1 third down so far in the game. Deion Williams received the snap, pass to number 6. Gerald Warsham up the gut, but he's stopped well short of a first down. Looks like the Tigers are going to have to go back and punt again.
That was number 12, Stevie Harden, in on a tackle. Williams was able to get the pass off. It was a screen set up for Warsham, but then, as you can see, he was brought down quickly by Steve Hardy, who is actually a Valdosta native, playing for his hometown team, the Blazers.
This is the 5th punt for the Tigers tonight. Number 80, Chris Wellborn, back for the Blazers to receive. The kick is a little high, whistles everywhere. Don't see a flag on the field, though. So far, VSU struggling a little bit on their punt returns. Longest punt return is of 5 yards tonight. Oh, and something disheartening for the VSU Blazers. They get tagged with an illegal substitution penalty, which gives the Tigers an automatic first down in Blazer territory.
This is as close as they've came to being actually able to put some points on the board here all night, thanks to this Blazer defense being extremely stingy.
That's the 5th penalty for the Blazers, 35 yards off of all 6th penalty for the Blazers. Offense back on the field after that penalty by the Blazers. 1st and 10 on the 40. William hands it off to number 23.
Roosevelt Ross once again picking up pretty good yardage for the WAB school. I know the Blazers must have a pretty nasty taste in their mouth after they gave up a 100-yard rushing game to K.J. Johnson, who had 106 yards in the very first half when they was over at Wichita. I'm pretty sure they're trying not to let that happen again here tonight, but if they keep playing like this, Roosevelt will.
Tigers 2nd and 4 on the Blazers 34. Handoff again to Roosevelt, going up the gut. Gain of about 3-4 maybe on the play. Still well short of a first down. 7:18 left in the first half, 21-0, VSU on top. 3rd and 2nd, ball in the 33 for the Tigers. This quite possibly could be the farthest the Tigers have gotten into VSU territory so far this game.
And it looks as if the Blazers, I'd expect the Blazers defense to be a little more fresh since they haven't really been on the field that much tonight, but who knows, maybe if they can cut out the silly penalties, they'll be able to get off the field once again.
Tigers offense, number 23, Roosevelt in the backfield, low snap. Williams recovers it, looking for a passer in the pocket all day. Passes to Roosevelt, who comes up well past first down, but it looks like there's a fumble on the field. No indication by the refs as to who caught it or if it is a confirmed fumble or not. Tigers have recovered the fumble, giving them a first down. Now will be 1st and 10 for the Tigers on the Blazer 25-yard line. Actually reversed. Blazers picked up the fumble, recovered the ball. Great heads-up play by the Blazers. That was just a big hodgepodge of players in the middle of the field.
And just when you think West Alabama's about to put something together offensively, they go ahead, they get the ball to the open receiver who just gets just a little too ahead of himself and loses the ball. And now the Blazers have once again have the ball and have the opportunity to put more points on the board.
That's actually VSU's first recovered fumble for the season for tonight.
As you can see here, Roosevelt, he gets hit just as soon as he's tackled, and he drops the ball.
Looks like Carlos Anderson came up behind him and maybe swatted it out. He was really coming at him fast. Kellen Lewis back on the field. VSU offense, high snap, brings it down, handoff to Ronnie Nelson, up to get a gain of maybe one or two at the most, possibly even a loss on the play. Botched snap to Kellen, possibly ruined the whole play for him, but very good recovery. 6:25 left here at Bazemore-Hyder Stadium. It's 21-0. Blazers on top. Second and 9 for the Blazers on their own 25-yard line.
No gain for the Blazers. It's second down and 10.
No gain on that play for Ronnie Nelson. Lined up again. Ronnie Nelson in the backfield. Lewis receives the pass. Passes it to number 82, Cody Case. Caught on the 42-yard line. First down for the Blazers, gain of about 10 or 11.
As you can see, Kellen Lewis draws back and he finds Cody Case over the middle, but it looks as if it might have been a little pass interference by number two on that play, Tariq Ali, but it looks as if the refs are going to let him play.
Ronnie Nelson in motion on this play. Fake handoff, Lewis looking for a receiver, deep ball to Cody Case again. Jackson Dean on the reception, number 84. He catches it at the Blaze at the UWA 31-yard line. Another first down for the Blazers. It's now first and 10 on the Tigers' 31-yard line.
And this is what I've seen from the Blazers in practice. When they run the hurry-up offense, they're very efficient.
Cody Kellen Lewis gets a hand, gets a pass, passes it to number 8, Cedric Jones. Gain of about 6 on the yard. Jones just fighting for every single yard this game. He is being very physical.
This is a breakout statement game for Seth Jones. I guess he feels as if he has to make up for that miss at Wachita Baptist, where he wasn't
Absolutely.
Able to help his team come away with the victory.
Ronnie Nelson still in the backfield for the Blazers. Jackson Dean lined up on the far side. Pass again to Jones. Looks like a screen. Broken play, though. Taken down in the backfield. Possible loss of 1.
There was now 19, Sherrill Ford. He's been all over the field tonight. That's about his 4th tackle here tonight, isn't it, Mike?
He is everywhere. 3rd and 5. For the Blazers on the Tigers' 26-yard line, 21-0, still the score. Blazers on top. The clock has ticked under 5 minutes in the first half. Blazers seem to have went away from the hurry-up offense, kind of started to slow things down. Ronnie Nelson still in the backfield. Lewis receives the snap, pass to Isaiah Jupiter over the middle at the 13-yard line. First down for the Blazers and 3 yards from being first and goal. Here in the red zone, and they are threatening once again.
And I'm pretty sure Kellen Lewis is loving the protection that he's receiving from his offensive line, something he hasn't seen pretty much all season.
Hand off to Ronnie Nelson, runs to the right side, gains, gets a hole, but it's immediately closed, and an only gain of about 4 yards on the play.
And once you pass enough, thanks to Kellen Lewis being able to stand back in the pocket and find his men wide open downfield, he's able to hand the ball off to Ronnie Nelson, who can pick up pretty good yardage, thanks to the cornerbacks and the linebackers playing off, expecting another pass.
Like you said, Trey, seems like the offensive line has been holding up very well for Kellen Lewis, giving him a lot of time. We're going to take a quick break here at VSU-TV, 21-0 with 4 minutes left here at Bazemore-Hyder Stadium.
If a chronic illness is driving you apart, call 1-800-344-4867, because a healthy relationship matters.
Welcome back to Bazemore-Hyder Stadium, courtesy of VSU-TV. It is 21-0, VSU on top with 4:04 left in the quarter.
And that was number 14, J.D. Douglas, who got a little shaken up on the last play. I wonder how well this West Alabama defense would fare without their best player out there on the field, but it hasn't made that much of a difference here tonight.
Not very much at all. 2nd and 4 for the Blazers. Ball on the 7-yard line, 21-0 with 3:50 left. Direct snap to Ronnie Nelson, and he is in. Touchdown, Blazers. 27-0 now for the Blazers with 3:50 left on the clock.
This is the fastest start the Blazers have gotten off to all season. 28 points in the first half.
Blazers lining up for the PAT to make it 28-0. Kick is up, kick is good. It is 28-0 for VSU.
Your score attempt is good. Your score with 3 minutes and 49 seconds.
3:49 left here in the first half.
Tigers, nothing.
VSU driving straight down the field into Tigers territory and coming away with a touchdown by Ronnie Nelson.
Once again, the Blazers are capitalized on a turnover by West Alabama. It only took them 8 plays to take the ball 76 yards and only 2 minutes and 49 seconds. The Blazers are very, very dangerous whenever they are able to score quickly. If the Blazers hold the ball for more than 5 minutes, it's very rare that they're actually able to come away with a touchdown.
So far, this seems like a completely different Blazer team than what we saw at Ouachita Baptist and at the home opener in Newberry. This team is playing with confidence. They're playing the secondary. The whole defense is trusting each other, and they're doing a pretty good job of putting pressure on Deion Williams and making him seem extremely uncomfortable in the pocket.
And this is what Coach Dean wanted his team to do, develop a sense of trust within each other and let everyone know that even if your man does get beat, you don't necessarily have to do the other man's job. Let that man do his job, you do your job, and at the end of the day, everything will work out. And it looks as if all that preaching has finally settled in, and now the Blazers are out here doing what Coach Dean wants them to do, come away with the win. If they can continue to play at the same high level that they have thus far.
That is a big if, Trey. We'll see what the second half brings up. VSU on the field to kick it off. Terry Allen, big threat for the Tigers, sitting, lurking, waiting for the ball to be kicked to him. And it is kicked high. Terry Allen fields it at the 10, and he is off to the races. Up, breaking a few tackles, finally brought down at the 28-yard line of the Tigers. Minimum return, no more than about 15 on that. Very, very good if you look at how well Allen has done in previous games returning the ball.
He brings it back to the West Alabama 28-yard line.
3:43 left here to play in the first half. Blazers up 28-0. Tigers get the ball first and 10 on their own 28-yard line. They have a lot of green in front of them, Trey.
And Terry Allen is doing everything he can to help this offense on special teams. He has 4 returns so far for 81 yards.
Williams and 23 in the backfield. Williams gets the snap looking for a man. He has pressure and is brought down and fumble. Fumble brought down by number 51, Tommy Duhart.
The Pitt transfer, Mr. Tommy Duhart, in there with a big hit, and it looks as if Williams is down. Yeah, here you can see right here on the play, Williams was trying to find a man, but then Tommy Duhart was able to get into it in the backfield and make the big play, and he slams him pretty hard and looks as if he might have fell onto his shoulder.
Schneider Sneeder came up after that to make a play on the loose ball. Fortunately, it was not a fumble, or else it would be Blazers' first down. Injured man on the field, it is Tigers quarterback Deion Williams.
Yeah, he took a pretty hard fall right there when Tommy Duhart came in for the tackle.
It's 3:31 left in the first half. 28-0 is your score. We're going to take a quick break. You are watching VSU-TV.
Filing for Social Security online is a lot easier than relearning the Watusi.
Welcome back to Bazemore-Hyder Stadium. Blazers leading 28-0. Deion Williams carted off the field on a stretcher. Hopefully he's going to be all right. New quarterback for the Tigers, Gary Johnston, a 5'9", 173 freshman from Gulf Shores, Alabama. We'll see how this works for Tigers. Automatically a deep throw by Johnston, broken up by number 26 of the Blazers,
true freshman Matt Pierce.
Great play by the Blazers. Secondary all over the wide receiver, Michael Townsend, who was the intended receiver. Flag on the play, though. Still awaiting official word as to what the flag. It's against VSU. Backing up backing up the VS or the, making the Tigers move forward. It's now second and 11, second and 10 with the ball on the 30-yard line. 28-0, VSU still on top, 3:13 left in the first half. Johnston, number 12, awaiting the snap. Number 3, Michael Townsend in motion. Handoff, number 29, Brandon Tisdale. Or no, number 23, I'm sorry, Roosevelt Ross with that carry up the middle.
Number 9, Damian Baylor, ball carrier. He gains 4 yards on the carry.
2:55 left here to play in the first half. It's 28-0. Blazers on top. Second and 6 for the Tigers. Ball on their own 34-yard line. If you're just tuning in, Tigers going with their backup quarterback now, Gary Johnston, true freshman. Terry Allen receives the ball. Or no, that is Damian Baylor receiving the ball. Strike right up the middle. Immediately met by a swarm of black VSU defenders, and it seems like there's an injured player on the field, running back Damian Baylor. 3rd and 4 for the Tigers, ball on their 36-yard line, 2:21 left to play, 28-0, Blazers on top. The Philosophy and Religious Studies Club is having a bake sale on Tuesday, September 29th from 10 a.m. until 5 p.m. Items such as chocolate pudding, pound cakes, and several types of cookies will be available for purchase. Call Morgan Roberts at 251-3343 for more information or to place an order.
With 2 minutes and 21 seconds left to go in the quarter, Valdosta State is up 28-0. It's about to be halftime in a little while. All right, we'll be back after these few messages.
I'm Jessica Mendoza, U.S. Olympic gold and silver medalist. I never take my eyesight for granted. Neither should you. Doesn't matter how old you are, you could be losing your vision to glaucoma without knowing it. Take care of your sight. Schedule regular eye exams for yourself and those you love. Call 1-800-437-2423 or go to ahaf.org for free information and publications from National Glaucoma Research.
Welcome back to Bazemore-Hyder Stadium. VSU on top 28-0 with 2:21 left to play in the second quarter. Tigers have the ball, 3rd and 4 on their own 36. True freshman quarterback Gary Johnston waiting to receive the snap. He receives it, looks for a pass, throws it to number 23, Roosevelt Ross, and he is 21, Terry Levy, and he is pushed out of bounds by Larry Dean. Not enough for the first down. It's going to be 4th and inches for the Tigers. Maybe 1st and 1, but fourth and one, but barely. Ball is on their 39-yard line. Timeout by Valdosta State. It's 1:55 left in. 1:55 left in the first half, 28-0, VSU on top. We'll be right back on VSU-TV after these short messages.
Valdosta, Georgia. It's all you need. With innovative minds that feed a thriving business environment, all with access to international contacts, and a university influence with championship teams. It's premier healthcare, and a community that's metropolitan, yet inviting. Valdosta, Georgia, all you need.
Welcome back to VSU-TV. We're here at Bazemore-Hyder Stadium. 1:55 left in the half, 28-0, VSU on top. True freshman Tigers quarterback Gary Johnston trying to get this 4th and 1 for his team. It is 4th and 1 on their 39. Handoff to 23, Roosevelt Ross, and he gets the first down. Gain of about 4 on the play, bringing the Tigers to their own 43-yard line.
Just before that carry, Roosevelt Ross was actually averaging 5 yards per rush on the ground.
Johnston receives the snap and drops it. He's immediately flushed out of his out of the pocket with a slew of defenders tracing him, almost trips up, and head-to-head contact with Tony.
Number 24, Carlos Anderson, there to make the stop, so he didn't get the first down.
Number 12, Gary Johnston with the keeper.
Great coverage by the VSU defenders not to allow them to get up and get that first down. It's now second and two, ball on the 49-yard line. VSU still on top, 28-0 with 1:36 left in the half. Johnston waiting for the snap. Next to Roosevelt Ross is him in the backfield. Tony Allen on the far side. Defensive encroachment on 97. Flags thrown. This is a free play for the Tigers. And the freshman quarterback throws it up for grabs, but no one's there to even attempt to grab it.
If he was able to get his hips turned around and set his feet to throw that ball downfield, that would have been a very big play for West Alabama.
It's a little bit easier to say than to do, especially whenever you got four linemen coming at you.
Yeah, a lot of the things that are said about football are easier said than done, Mike. I promise you that.
Again, that penalty was on the Blazers. False start by number 97. Melvin Black cost the Blazers 5 yards. It's now second and two for the Tigers. No, it's first and 10 for the Tigers on the 44-yard. Johnston stripped of the ball. Fumble. VSU looks like they have recovered. Mad dog pile right on the 43-yard line. And no, UWA has recovered the ball. Fumble by number 12, Gary Johnston. The ball appeared to be ripped directly from his hands as he tried to make a throw. Really, really heavy pressure by the VSU defense. Here it is now. He's looking. Two defenders, 32 and 94 on him. 56 comes in to make the tackle. 94, Demetrius Bozeman. Looks like he's the one that forced the fumble.
That was actually number 32, the defensive leader for the Blazers, Larry Dean, in there stripping Johnston of the ball.
Highlights of tonight's game on the David Dean Football Show each Sunday on WALB.
Don't forget to watch VSU-TV for the latest local, state, and national news on VSU-TV News, airing live every Wednesday at 3 p.m. or catch the rebroadcast at 8 p.m. and again at 10:30. It's about 1:18 left to play in the first half. 28-0 is the score. Your Valdosta State Blazers on top. Second and 18 for the University of Western Alabama Tigers. Ball is on their own 48-yard line. This is a true test for their freshman quarterback. Gary Johnston, who has come into play for injured starting quarterback Deion Williams.
West Alabama is in a very difficult position without their starting quarterback Deion Williams back there taking the snaps, Mike.
Absolutely. A lot of pressure being put on this true freshman's shoulder, and we'll see how he stands up and delivers. Throw over the middle, intercepted. Almost intercepted by number 11, DeMarcus Flanagan, but he drops it. A very huge hit on that on number 12 as the play was ending.
That'll bring up third down and long for the Tigers.
Third down and 18 for the Tigers. Ball on their 48-yard line. Minute 13 left in the first half, 28-0. VSU on top.
And it looks to me as if the West Alabama team is just trying to get a little momentum going into the half, and hopefully they'll be able to come out and make something happen in third and fourth quarter.
Johnston with the pass to number six, Gerald Warsham, caught but tipped up in the air, incomplete for the Tigers. It's now fourth and 18, ball in the 48. West Alabama bringing out their punt team, number 80 for the Blazers, Chris Wellborn, set to receive the ball. So far, Blazers haven't averaged very good on their punt returns. Averaging have only have four punt returns for 19 yards. Tigers kick the ball to Wellborn. Sat there to field, takes it at the 16-yard line up the middle, brought down hard at the 26-yard line for the West Alabama Tigers.
Number 80, Chris Wellborn.
58 seconds left here in the first. VSU still way on top, 28-0. They're coming out on the field, first and 10, ball on their own 26. Blazers trying to put together another scoring drive before they go to halftime.
And I don't expect the Blazers to come out and try to put up any points here before going into the half. But then again, since they have Kellen Lewis and Ronnie Nelson in the backfield, you never know. But there's also a flag on the play. Let's check the flag, Mike.
Blazers had just came out to set up their offensive formation when a flag was thrown. It's an illegal substitution to the Blazers. Penalties starting to be a factor in this game, even though Blazers are up 28-0.
First down and 15 for the Blazers.
Right now we have nine penalties for 60 yards. Not 108 yards like last game, but it's starting to get close. Kellen with the snap, looking force out of the pocket, running forward, brought down hard at the 25-yard line by number 48, Dwayne Perryman.
You still don't like to see your team play this sloppy, even in the first half. This is the first half, and they already have 60 yards worth of penalties that they've racked up, which isn't good, but it's not hurting the Blazers too much.
Lewis receives the snap, looking for a wide receiver. There's Cody Case with the catch. Jackson Dean with the catch at the 30-yard line. 25 seconds left, and the clock is ticking. Looks like the Blazers. The half. Blazers up 28-0 here at Bazemore-Hyder. Lewis with the snap, looking for a receiver. He's got plenty of time. Pass over the middle, short for number 19, Gerald Ford.
We have 8 seconds left here on the clock, and I expect the Blazers to maybe just try to go ahead and maybe take a snap and try to run the clock out. But this first half has been all the Blazers. No, it looks like they bring the punt team out, but this first half has been all Blazers. The Blazers have had 15 first downs, whereas West Alabama has only had 6.
Fulford, okay. Jack Fulford out to punt for the Blazers. Number 6, Gerald Worsham back to catch for the Tigers. And the punt hits on the 30-yard line at the very, very sideline and rolls all the way down to the Tigers 10, and that, ladies and gentlemen, will end the first half. 28-0 here at Bazemore-Hyder Stadium. We're going to take a quick break here on VSU-TV.
The penalty is a legal procedure charged to the Blazers.
Welcome back to Bazemore-Hyder Stadium. Clock reads 0. We still have to play one last play here to end the second half. Blazers coming out to punt again. Number 6.
They're actually going to take a knee on this one.
Number 6, Gerald Worsham back to receive. Blazers taking a knee. Smart thing to do. And that officially ends this first half of football here at Bazemore-Hyder Stadium. 28-0, VSU on top. Earlier this week, I spoke to All-American wideout Cedric Jones. I asked him what it would mean to him to have a record-breaking season.
It feels great. It feels great. And being that I worked hard in all 4 years, I feel like I kind of deserve to be in this position, and I hope that happens.
Jones has amassed 88 yards with 1 touchdown in 2 games for the Blazers. He now only needs 15 receptions to be the all-time leader, not only at VSU, but in the Gulf South Conference. Coach Dean had this to say about his wide receiver's determination.
Find Cedric Jones in the middle of the field.
Well, we probably don't have a receiver that works any harder than Cedric Jones. He comes out to practice every day, and he works to get better. He goes through every drill as fast as he can go. A lot of times you see him, he doesn't look like he's moving that fast in between plays, but when the ball's snapped, he's actually moving. And, I can't say enough about him and how his work ethic has made him a better football player, and that's the reason why he's so close to all those records.
About a year ago, Mark and I thought, air pollution, global warming, how can we make a difference? So Mark modified our car some sort of homemade energy source.
The best part is the car emits only helium.
Genius.
Genius.
But the EPA says the energy we use in our home can cause twice the greenhouse gases of a car. So now I look for products that are in the Energy Star. Simple.
The EPA invites you to go to EnergyStar.gov to discover what you can do to reduce air pollution.
The stem cell issue is being debated throughout the country. Truth is, most everyone has an opinion, even if they don't know the facts.
Let's stop arguing and start really understanding the potential of stem cell research.
For us and for millions of Americans living with disabilities, get the facts.
Call 1-877-842-3442 for free information from the Stem Cell Research Foundation. That's 1-877-842-3442.
Every year, 350,000 people are diagnosed with Alzheimer's disease. Who will be their caregivers?
I am a caregiver.
Yo soy la que cuida a mi abuelo.
I'm a caregiver.
Call 1-800-437-2423 for a free brochure from Alzheimer's Disease Research on caring for those you care for the most. 1-800-437-2423.
I'm a caregiver. Mom.
Welcome back to Bazemore-Hyder Stadium, home of your Valdosta State Blazers. Start of the third quarter, Blazers up 28-0. I'm your host, Mike Slater. Right next to me, my co-host, Trey Williams. So far, Valdosta has put up some very impressive numbers. They have 189 passing yards with 63 ground yards on the ground and a total of 15 first downs.
And so far, the Blazers have been on the offense have been on the field for 47 plays and amassed 252 yards total.
Justin Kramer here to kick off to the Tigers. Terry Allen set deep to return the ball. And here it comes. Blazer kickoff starting the third quarter here at Bazemore-Hyder Stadium. Allen with the reception at about the 6-yard line. Tries right up the middle, brought down by a host of VSU defenders.
Yeah, that was number 22 and 24 in there on the tackle. Number 24 being Carlos Sanderson and 24 being Marcel Horn. Mr. All Purpose is doing what he has to do once again. I seen him taking a slow jog as he made his way towards the 20, but then as soon as he thought he saw a hole open up, he tried to explode right there at the end, but he didn't get much because the Blazers closed the hole just as soon as it opened.
Number 12 for the Tigers, freshman Gary Johnson back on the field. Update on Deion Williams. He has gotten feeling in his and it's a shovel pass and fumbled. Number 9, Damian Baylor, hit hard on the play, made the ball come out. Luckily, the ball went out of bounds before VSU could recover that fumble.
And that was number 24, Carlos Anderson, in there to make a play. He is the senior leader on the defensive side of the ball. At least he was at the beginning of the season until they added Rashard Etheridge to the lineup. But Carlos Anderson is out here making heads-up plays, something we haven't seen much of all season.
14:45 left in the third quarter, 28-0 Blazers on top. Second down and 10 for the Tigers on their own 24-yard line. Johnston receives the ball, holds it, pass to the middle, caught by 6, but immediately dropped.
That was number 6, Gerald Warsham, getting open over the middle. And he is actually their leading receiver on the season thus far, but he's had a very off night here tonight. Maybe the quarterback hasn't had much time to get his star wide out the ball.
I've noticed since Johnston has gotten into the game, he's tried a lot of over-the-middle passes. Sooner or later, that's going to catch up with him, and he's going to be met with a Valdosta State linebacker.
I'm pretty sure that the VSU defensive backs are just salivating, waiting for him to give them one that they can take back the other way.
And it's a flag on the play as immediately when Johnston hikes the ball. Number 97, Melvin Black, in the backfield almost the same time as the ball is hiked. That's a defensive offside on the Blazers. Another penalty for VSU. Going into halftime, they had 10 penalties for 65 yards. Now here's number 11.
Defense. Number 97, 5-yard penalty, still third down.
Number 44, Ratua Bella, happened to get shaken up a little bit on the play. He tried to get off the field under his own power, but it seems as if he won't be able to make it. The training staff is out now checking on him.
Third and 10 for the Tigers on their 24-yard line. Matua Bellum is off the field now, under his own power. Third and five for the Tigers. Ball on their 29-yard line. 4:23 left to go in the third quarter here at Bazemore-Hyder Stadium.
West Alabama is in a very different position here with their freshman quarterback coming into the game, who has not really been game tested here throughout this season.
Johnston calling the play, waiting for the ball to be hiked to him. Moving up to his offensive line, looks like he might be calling an audible. Johnston receives very low snap. 33, Larry Dean after him. No, Dean makes a tackle on him, forcing Johnston
12,
to take
Johnston.
A hit on at their own 24-yard line.
As you can see, it was a low snap that caused this, and then it also gave the Blazers a chance to get in the backfield. You see number 27 and 33 is Chauncey. The boys got back there until he was able to get Larry Dean slowed him down. Then eventually number 27, Donald Maxwell, was able to stay into the play to come up with the tackle.
That's 4th and 11 now for the Tigers as they punt. Chris Wellborn back for the Blazers to receive. Ball is kicked low and short. Barely gets past the 50, bounces back to the Blazers, or the West Alabama side of the 50. Blazers will get the ball on the West Alabama 49-yard line. That last series, it seemed like West Alabama was safe, facing the same problem the Blazers were last week in a very quick collapsing pocket.
Yeah, it looks as if the Blazers have went back to all the game tapes and found all the weaknesses and tried to improve on them. And so far, so good by the Blazers.
Blazer offense taking the field, led by number 15, Kellen Lewis. R.J. Bastone and Gerald Ford on the near side. Both Cedrics on the far side. Cedric Jonas, Sed Evans. Kellen Lewis keeps the ball, finds Gerald Ford, passes, caught, stumbled for a few extra yards, finally brought down by the Tigers at the Tigers' own 35-yard line. That was a gain of about 20 yards for Kellen Lewis. Lewis having a phenomenal day through the air. He's 22 for 30. And with that pass, has put him well over 200 yards on the game. Lewis again with the snap, fakes it to 25, and a little fade route to no one, thrown outside. Think he was trying to hit either Sed Evans or Sed Jones. Both of them were on the left side in the area Lewis was throwing the ball to. That brings up second and 10 on the 27 for the Blazers. 28-0 is the score. Blazers still on top, 12:47 left in the third quarter.
I'm going to tell you something about the Blazers. This is their eighth drive tonight, and so far on four out of seven drives, the Blazers have been able to come up with a touchdown.
Looks like Ronnie Nelson getting a little break. Michael Brown in the backfield. Lewin gets a snap right to Cedric Jones. Up past the 20. He's on the sideline. Makes a quick cut inside. And Cedric Jones is in for a touchdown. VSU scores again.
Making it 34 for the Blazers to the West Alabama nothing. As you can see here, Kellen Lewis signs Cedric Jones, was completely alone. Don't know how that happened, but he was able to break the tackle right there. Followed his blocker. Number one, Cedric Evans, from one Cedric to another, and he makes his way into the end zone.
Blazers lining up for the extra point attempt. Daniel Anderson for the kick. Good, trying to make it 35-0 for the Blazers. Kick is up, it is good, and it is 35-0 Blazers. 12:39 left here in the third quarter.
Your score with 12 minutes and 39 seconds remaining in the third quarter.
And the Blazers cap off their eighth drive of the night with the touchdown. So far, the Blazers are 50-50 when it comes to their drives here tonight, Mike.
It's a really impressive number, especially coming off such a hard loss last week. It's really great to see the Blazers have turned things around, at least so it seems. Except for the obvious fact of multiple penalties.
Correction there, Mike. I said they were 4 of 4, but in actuality, they're 5 out of 8, and that's pretty good. And for once, they actually didn't have any penalties on that drive, which is something that has been holding them back all night.
And what was what came out of that drive of no penalties?
A touchdown.
Exactly. Blazers seem to be doing everything right except for that little penalty thing. If they can clear that up, it seems like they have a nice road ahead of them. Still a tough one, though. Lots of heavy opponents in left for the Blazers to play. That was a 10-play drive, 65 yards. very quick. One of the quickest drives we've seen the Blazers have.
Five through eighth grade down to the field after the game to play catch with the VSU quarterbacks.
Kick team is on the field with 12:39 left to play, first and 10.
After the conclusion of tonight's game, and is sponsored by Brewster's Real Ice Cream, now being sold at every Blazers
35-0 is the score. Blazers on top. Justin Kramer out to kick the ball to the Tigers. Terry Allen waiting to receive. Ball's kicked. Low kick to the 10-yard line and bounces out of bounds. That's going to be a flag on the Blazers.
And you don't like to see it when your kicker kicks the ball out of bounds. That just puts the West Alabama offense in pretty good position to go ahead and maybe get on the board.
Automatically at the 40s, possibly the best starting field position for the Tigers so far today. They haven't been able to get into VSU territory very often this game.
But let's talk about Cedric Jones for a second. So far, Cedric Jones, 10 receptions, 90 yards, one touchdown. He's one catch away from being second all-time receptions in the GSE.
Very impressive numbers for our wide receiver there.
West Alabama will accept the ball 30 yards from the spot of the kick. First down.
Obviously missing last week, Ced came out looking to prove himself to not only his team but to Blazer Nation. And it seems like Blazer Nation is very thankful for his dedication.
And if Ced Jones can keep this up, you might want to try to hide the record books because it might get ugly.
12:39 left to play. Blazer D on the field. Freshman quarterback Gary Johnston ready to receive. Low snap by the Tigers. Throw to number 21, Terry Levy. Wide receiver for the Tiger. Gain of 2 will bring
Johnston's
up second and 8. Ball on the 43-yard line for the West Alabama Tigers. Left here in the third quarter. Second and 8, ball on the 42. Johnston has a man in motion, number 6, Gerald Warsham. Handoff to 23, Roosevelt Ross, right up the middle, met with a giant swarm of VSU defenders. Maybe a 2-yard gain, maybe.
I really didn't expect to see that much of Roosevelt Ross tonight since their leading rusher on the team is Damian Baylor. I haven't seen him do much. So far on the evening, Damian Baylor has 7 attempts for 18 yards, whereas Roosevelt has 7 attempts for 37. So I guess they're trying to go with what's working.
Seems like they're lining up Damian Baylor more often to be a wide out than actually be a running back. Interesting strategy, but if it gets some yards, it's obviously working. Johnston in the backfield, changing the play, waiting for the snap. VSU defense waiting hungrily. Johnston passes way over the head of number 6, Gerald Warsham. Warsham gets a hand on it, tips the ball in the air. Very lucky there wasn't a VSU defender around to pick that ball.
Yeah, number 12, Stevie Harden was right there to make the tackle just in case it was a completion, but I think he still would have had enough just for the first down.
3 and out for the West Alabama Tigers. Again, Chris Wellborn back to receive the kick from the Tigers. Or no, a little confusion on the Blazers. Thought they were going for a punt. They, in fact, are going to go for it on this 4th and 5 and call a timeout. Valdosta does. It's 11:14 here at Bazemore-Hyder Stadium. We'll take a quick break here on VSU-TV.
Valdosta State University Small Business Development Center provides consulting, seminars, and research to entrepreneurs.
As my business has faced new challenges, I've seen the benefits of an ongoing relationship with VSU's Small Business Development Center. They've made a huge difference.
Why not add your name to the growing number of clients taking advantage of free and confidential services and take your business to the next level?
Welcome back to Bazemore-Hyder Stadium. 11:14 left in the third quarter, 35-0, VSU on top. Tigers going for it on a 4th and 5 at their 45-yard line. No, they actually kick it high into the air. And it's muffed by Chris Wellborn. Luckily, he falls on the ball. No turnover for the Blazers, but they will start deep into their own territory at their own 19-yard line.
Those are the kind of plays that make you see a lot of the sideline if you're playing for Coach David Dean there, Mike.
little thing about West Alabama. Very bad punting night for them. They've went to the air. That was their seventh punt on the night, and they've only averaged 29.5 yards per punt. Not very good if you're punting seven times a game. Blazer offense, back on the field, led by 15 Kellen Lewis. Number two, Derek Harris, is in the backfield. Haven't seen much of Ronnie Nelson lately. Guess he's taking a little break. R.J. Bastone on the near side. Bo Cedric's on the far. Handoff right to Derek Harris up to the left side. Jukes to the left and is met with a lot of defenders and taken down with a 1.5, maybe 2 yard gain.
And they're staying with the hurry-up offense here. I wonder why. Maybe they're trying to go ahead and get downfield. They might be trying just to keep the clock moving.
That's possible. It's 10:43 left here in this third quarter. 35-0 Blazers on top. Gerald Ford, R.J. Bastone on the near side. Both Cedric's on the far side. And, of course, Kellen Lewis behind center with Derek Harris right next to him. Kellen Lewis looking for a pass. Finds Cedric Evans for about a 4 yard game. Just short of the first down. It's going to be third and two, ball on the 22nd for VSU.
And Evans made a great catch right there and was able to hold on to it even while being tackled.
Kellen Lewis with the snap, flag in the air, deep throw to R.J. Bastone, caught. Amazing layout catch for R.J. Bastone, getting one foot inbounds. So if this flag does not repeal it, and it doesn't, that is a catch and a Blazers first down. R.J. Bastone picking up a good catch for the Blazers.
There are penalty flags in the backfield.
Offsides by the defense. The penalty is declined. Play stands. First down, Blazers. Great pass from Kellen Lewis.
That was a great pass by Kellen Lewis. He was able to keep his focus and find his man downfield for the big play.
And it really showed R.J. Bastone's heads up to keep that 1 foot inbound before he went out. Lewis lined up again behind center. Derek Harris right next to him. R.J. Bastone and Gerald Ford on the near side. Fake handoff. Pass to Isaiah Jupiter. Great catch. Brought down immediately, but enough for a first down. And they are at the West Alabama 13-yard line.
And the Blazer offense has been moving the ball at will out here pretty much all night. It seems as if the West Alabama defense doesn't have any answers for what this offense is doing.
VSU first and 10 on their 14-yard line in the red zone. Hand off to Derek Harris. Tries to go right, met with Fender, spins back to the middle, gets a yard or two at most, and is brought down by a slew of Tiger defenders.
Derek Harris rushes for a short gain on play.
Second and 9, ball in the 13, 35-0 still here. VSU on top, 9:20 left in the third quarter. Kellen Lewis, again, waiting for the snap. Derek Harris lined up again next to him. Seems like Ronnie Nelson might not see any more action tonight. He's been on the sideline for a minute. Lewis passes to Cedric, to Isaiah Jupiter. Hit him right in the chest, but Jupiter just flat out drops it.
Chantrell Ford was in the area. Maybe Isaiah Jupiter heard Chantrell Ford right behind him, thinking he was about to get lit up and wasn't able to keep his concentration.
Third and 9 now for the Blazers, still on the 13-yard line in the red zone, looking to score. Isaiah Jupiter and Sed Evans on the far side. Lewis with the snap. Little shovel pass to Derek Harris. Had open field to the right, but Derek Harris slid and only picked up a gain of maybe a yard. Might have even been a loss on the yard. He barely got out of the backfield.
The rain hasn't been much of a factor here tonight, but I've seen a couple of players out there slipping. Like when Deion Williams dropped back for a pass early, he slipped a little bit. But other than that, haven't seen too many players have a problem with the footing out there on the field.
Daniel Anderson now out to kick a field goal. Looks like it's going to be a 35-yarder, maybe 34-yarder. It's snapped. Kick is up. Kick is good. VSU is now up.
No good.
No, it is no good. Daniel Anderson missing that field goal. Score still 35-0 VSU. 8:18 left in the third quarter.
Catch the David Dean Show on VSU-TV every Monday at 9 p.m. and 11:30 p.m. Check TV Guide listings for other airings of the David Dean Show here on VSU-TV. Mule Riders starting deep in their own territory. Ball on the 20-yard line, first and 10.
Once again, that number is
818 left in the first half. Johnston with a pass to the left to Terry Allen. Allen hit, spun away from the defender, then hit by two more, brought down at the 25-yard line.
Once again, it's been a very quiet night for Terry Allen, Greg Worshman, and Damian Bailey. The four-headed monster of the West Alabama offense has been downgraded to three with the loss of Deion Williams, but they still have enough weapons out here to try to put some positive yardage up and try to put some points on the board.
I feel if the Tiger offensive line can give their quarterback a little bit more time, we could actually see the Tigers maybe make a successful drive downfield. But with the Black Swarm coming at them full force, I don't know if that's going to happen. Johnston receives a very low snap again, pass to his right to number six, Gerald Orsham. Gain of about six on the play. First down for West Alabama.
And it looks as if the Tigers are starting to play with a little sense of urgency now, seeing them go with the hurry-up style offense here. Maybe to try to go ahead and make some quick scores and try to put some points on the board.
First and 10 for the Tigers. Snap low. Pass out to number seven, Terry Allen. Fakes out one defender, but is runs into two more, brought down at the 42-yard line for the Tigers.
And there's Terry Allen, a.k.a. Mr. All-Purpose, showing that he's not only making a big impact on the special team, but he's also doing it in the passing game with this reception here until he's brought down by number 29 and number 36 on the Blazers defense, 29 being Devin Cannon and 36 being Sean Weathers.
Johnston back to receives the snap. Little pitch to Terry Allen running out to the right side. He is broken free and runs out of bounds before possibly getting lit up by one of the VSU safeties. Runs out of bounds at about the 36-yard line, but there are flags on the play. It has been raining yellow tonight. That's all I've got to say about it.
Yeah, I've seen a lot of litter going out there on the field.
There is a penalty marker on the field.
But the special thing I must say about Terry Allen is he is an all-around athlete. Not only is he a wide receiver, he also lines up at halfback as well as he returns punts and kickoffs.
That is a penalty against the Tigers, holding 10-yard penalty. Replay the first down. They're backed up into their own territory, 43-yard line. Just when the Tigers looked like they were going to get a break putting together two back-to-back first down plays, they get backed up by a really big holding call. Johnston awaiting the snap. VSU Blazers hungry on the defense. Rollout by the quarterback. Little pitch to number 23, Roosevelt Ross, who fumbles and bobbles a live ball on the ground. Blazers say they have it, and the refs confirm it. Blazers picked up the fumble.
And that was number 65, Jeremy Brown, defensive tackle. That is a lot of man moving around trying to come up with the loose ball. As you can see here, Johnston rolls out and he gives the pitch to number 23, who wasn't able to handle it. And then he was tackled by number 36, Sean Weathers. And the ball is still loose, and the Blazers attempted to jump on it there, but somehow it popped out again. And then you see there, number 65, he jumped in on the ball just before it went out of bounds. Great heads-up play by Jeremy Brown.
Obviously,
the Blazers got the ball.
Obviously, toss out to the left for the Tigers. Didn't work too well. Immediate pressure in the backfield. O-line collapsing. We have Mr. Russ Callaway, number 5, in as starting quarterback for the Blazers. Low snap to him. Hands it off to number 25,
Michael Brown.
Michael Brown makes a run to the left, can't really get any yardage, and is caught in the backfield. 2-yard loss on the play.
And it looks as if the Blazers have pretty much got to the point where they feel comfortable with this lead, and they're going to let their second team get a couple of snaps and let them get a feel for some real action game instead of those practice sessions that they're used to getting.
Great idea for Coach Dean to do this, especially with a team that is chock full of freshmen and sophomores, as this VSU team is. Russ Callaway takes the snap, hand off to Michael Brown. Now hand off to David Arnold, running and trucking up the right sideline for a first down for the Blazers. There are flags on the field again. This time it looks like it's going to be on the Blazers. The Blazers already walking back.
After two successful drives without a penalty at all, now the Blazers seem to have gotten back into that rhythm of where they used to getting a couple penalties on every drive.
Penalty was on Edward Gregory, the center, number 77 of the Blazers. It was a holding call. 10-yard loss for the Blazers. Second and no, it's second and 20. Second and 22. Ball on the 45 for the Blazers. Still up 35-0 though. VSU is 5:51 left in the third quarter. Russ Calloway waiting for the snap. Two running backs in the backfield with him. And another running play, handoff to David Arnold, makes it to the line of scrimmage and is just met with a massive group of Tiger defenders. Maybe gets back to the line if he's lucky. Number 70 on the VSU team, Edmund Kubala, lost his helmet on that, but didn't stop him. Saw him running right into the middle of that pile with no helmet on. Kind of dangerous, but it shows that he has great work ethic.
Has a big heart out there, Mike.
Russ Calloway right next to David Arnold. Russ keeps it, little screen pass to number 9, Owen Dixon, and is immediately hit on the line. No gain for the Blazers, and this will bring up fourth down and 23 to go on the Tigers' 46-yard line.
And the Tigers are still playing with a lot of intensity out here, even though they're on the opposite, on the wrong end of the scoreboard here.
This will bring out number 39, Jack Fuller, to punt again.
The Blazers have fourth down and 22 at the 45-yard line.
Terry Allen is not lined up to receive for West Alabama. The kick is in the air, high and shallow. Waved, fair catch by Tigers. They will start their drive at the 14-yard line. It's 4:20 left to go in the third quarter. Tigers about to start their own drive on their own 14-yard line. Well, last series, Tigers were able to put together two back-to-back first down plays, but then the offensive line, it seemed like, just kept breaking apart for them, and their quarterback, Johnston, just couldn't get a ball out correctly. Blazers D back on the field, ready to defend against Johnston and these Tigers' offense. Gary Johnston receives the handoff, looking for someone downfield, makes a throw
to his halfback number 9, Damian Baylor, but the pass was a little too high and he was unable to come down with the completion.
Good coverage by the VSU defense on this. There was no man open and immediate pressure by the D-line, forcing Gary Johnston to roll out, which obviously looks like he's not very comfortable in doing.
And this is a situation where you wouldn't want to be going into a game like this with an untried freshman playing quarterback.
A lot of pressure on a true freshman. And quarterback keep trying to draw up the middle, gain of 3 or 4 yards. Really risky play to be sending your freshman quarterback right up the middle, especially being met by a big defensive line of VSU.
Johnson's stats look very promising coming into this game. He's only played in 3 games, but so far he had 8 attempts for 5 completions. He also had a 62% passing percentage with 112 yards and 2 touchdowns. But who was he playing against when this happened?
That's a good question. Blazers secondary giving a lot of room for these wide receivers. Immediate pressure on Johnston. Wobbly throw deep, and it is caught at the 45-yard line by number 9, Damian Baylor. No, number 8, I'm sorry, Randy Lowry. Good for a first down and much, much more for the Tigers. First successful play they've had this drive so far.
They've been able to put together a couple successful plays, but the thing is, it seems as if they tend to burn out after they screen together a couple.
3:22 left here in the third quarter. 35-0 Blazers still on top. First and 10 on the 47. Number 12 rolling out, is just being chased down by 3 VSU defenders, rolling back to the right, finds number 8 wide open, Randy Lowry, but he drops it. Drop catch leads to the interception, second and 10, ball on the 47 for the Tigers. 3:09 left to play in this quarter.
I can tell you one thing, Mike. If I'm Gary Johnston, I see number 51 Tommy Duhart, who's 6'4", 323 pounds, a pure man, coming at me. I'm going to throw the ball away as fast as I can, too.
Heck, I'd actually just give him the ball and run the other way, but that's me. 3 minutes left here to play, 35-0. Blazers have a very commanding lead. As we stated earlier, lots of substitutions for the Blazer, letting a lot of people get some experience and game time experience. Great, great strategy for Coach Dean, especially with a defense that has so many freshmen on it. Timeout taken by Valdosta. 3:09 left, timeout by West Alabama. 3:09 left in the third quarter, 35-0. We'll take a quick break here on VSU-TV.
Welcome to Valdosta State University. Beautiful, isn't it? Are you upset about pesticides in your food, crude oil in your oceans, littering in our streets, clear-cutting of national forests, the killing of dolphins and sea turtles, destruction of wetlands? Now's the time to join Students Against Violating the Environment. SAVE helps by raising awareness among the student and faculty body about environmental issues on campus, in the community, and around the world. It's easy to make a difference. Simply call this number and join SAVE. Think globally, act locally.
Welcome back to Bazemore-Hyder Stadium, home of your Valdosta State Blazers. They are up 35-0, 3:09 left in the third quarter. I am Mike Slater, your host. Right next to me, Trey Williams. Very, very good defensive game for the Blazers, giving up very minimal yards, forcing the Tiger quarterback to roll out a lot. Speaking of which, direct handoff to him, pass, shovel pass to number 23, Roosevelt Ross, gains about 4 yards on the play. It'll be third and six for the Tigers.
And that was number 42, Dudley Spencer, there on the tackle. As you can see, he pitches off to Roosevelt Ross here, who was able to pick up a couple yards before he was brought down by number 12, 36, and 33. A host of Blazers there to make the play.
Black swarm if I've ever seen it. 2:30 left in the third, 35-0. VSU still the score. Tigers trying to put together some semblance of a scoring drive, finally into VSU territory. Johnson receives the handoff, pass to Terry Allen, broken up as he is immediately hit by VSU defenders.
And that was number 29, Devin Cannon, coming in there at the last second, putting a big hit on Terry Allen. As you can see here, Johnson finds him, at least he thinks he has him wide open, but there you see Mr. 29, Devin Cannon, coming across to make the big hit.
Fourth and four, ball on the 47 for the Tigers. No punter on the field. Quarterback and offense still out there. We do have number 80, Chris Wellborn, back to receive in case it is a fake punt situation. But it looks like they're going for it. Fourth and four, and the Tigers are going for it. Big stop for the VSU Blazers if they can stop them here. Low snap, very low snap. But it looks like it was caused by a possible offsides.
Part of the snap.
2:22 left here in the third quarter, 35 up. False start on the Tigers, moving them back. Offsides on the Tigers, moving them back. Fourth down and 9 now. Tigers still going for this on fourth down and 9. Gary Johnson receives. Oh, Gary Johnson kicks it, little quarterback punt. And it rolls out at the VSU 10-yard line. Little trick play there, caught the VSU off guard. Luckily, though, no big play came of it, and Blazers start it deep in their own territory. It's 2:14 left here in this third quarter. Blazers up 35-0.
And don't forget to take advantage.
And so far, very impressive showing by both sides of the ball by the VSU team. The offense has come out and they've been able to put together a good few series of drives here to put points on the board, and the defense has been able to prevent the other team from scoring.
Second team offense on the field for Valdosta State. Russ Calloway hands it off to number 10, David Arnold, pounding up to the left side, gains of about 2 yards on the play. Second and 8 for the Blazers, 2:01 left here in the third quarter.
Derek Harris, the ball carrier, no gain on the play. It's second down and 10.
Derek Harris in the backfield with Russ Calloway. 84 Jackson Dean and RJ Bassone on the near side. Russ Calloway looking to pass, scrambling out. Little short pass to 84 Jackson Dean, and it is well short of Jackson Dean, possibly by a good 5 yards. Russ Calloway looking as nervous as Gary Johnson is whenever he's rolling out.
No, he just looks as if he's not very comfortable trying to throw the ball on the run. When he got outside of the pocket, he just threw the ball down, and he tried to get it to his open receiver, but he threw it at his feet instead of towards his hands.
You just got to ask yourself, how much is this? How much of a factor is Russ's brace in this whole mobility? Russ again in the backfield waiting the snap. Number two, Derek Harris, right next to him. Low snap, recovers it, pass to R.J. Bastone in the backfield, gets up to the line of scrimmage, maybe a yard.
Pass is complete to number six, R.J. Bastone.
Defenders were almost immediately in the backfield. Complete breakdown of the O-line. Russ didn't have very much time at all in the pocket. Luckily got the ball out before he took a sack, and he was close enough as to where it could have been even a safety.
And another good thing is it was a completion, which keeps the clock running, so this makes the game just a little bit shorter for the Blazers.
1:10 left here in the third quarter, 35-0 still the score. Valdosta State a commanding lead, number 38. Jack Fullard out to punt for the Blazers. Number six,
Jared Worsham
to return. Terry Allen has not returned the past two punts for the Tigers. Worsham receives, juking back and forth, but cannot escape the VSU Blazer defense, and the Black Swarm brings him down into his own territory at about the Tigers' 48-yard line.
And that was number 31, Ryan Smith, the freshman linebacker in there breaking that up. As you can see right there, he's already in on the play. He gets a hand on him and makes sure he doesn't get away and brings him down.
Very risky move by the Tigers to not call a fair catch on that play. Blazer defenders were less than 10 yards away whenever he caught the ball. Tigers should be lucky they actually caught onto that. The Blazers didn't pummel him and force a fumble. Freshman quarterback Gary Johnston back on the field, hoping to put together a scoring drive for his Tigers. VSU defense out there looking as mean as ever. False start, it looks like, on the Valdosta State. Flags thrown. There's a handoff to Russ, to Roosevelt. Russ, he has gone up the left side, steps out of bounds at the 8-yard line. Do not know if this play will stand. There is a flag on the field.
And it looked as if it might have been offsides on the Blazers by number 96, Snyder Senius, who jumped off just a little bit early.
I think you may be correct, Trey, because they are moving up. That play will stand. It is offsides on the Blazers. And for, I want to say, the first time, the Tigers are in the red zone trying to score on the Blazers.
Something they're all too unfamiliar with tonight, Mike.
Something the Tigers are unfamiliar with is their freshman quarterback, who has been the only one to lead the Tigers into the red zone. Deion Williams failed to do that in the first half. Gary Johnson, man in motion, waiting the snap, receives a handoff to 23, Roosevelt Ross, pounding up the left side, gain of 1 yard before
Ross,
the entire Blazer team, it seems like, took him down.
And that is Roosevelt Ross' 12th carry of the night.
He's been their go-to running, which is surprising. He's not even the starter for them.
He's inching a little bit closer to that 100-yard stat, but this is the Blazers' second team defense, so, I mean, even though it is a second team defense, you still expect them to go out and play as hard as they can.
End of the third quarter, 35-0. We'll take a quick break here on VSU-TV.
I never thought I'd miss you half as much as I do. It must be love, love, love. It must be love.
It must be love. It must be hospice.
Welcome back here at Bazemore-Hyder Stadium. 35-0, Valdosta State on top. UWA, West Alabama Tigers in the red zone trying to put up some numbers. Get rid of that goose egg on the score. Freshman quarterback trying to make a throw. It is tipped by number 29, Roosevelt Ross, as he tries to make the catch, but it is incomplete.
Quarterback was under heavy pressure, and he just did what he had to do to try to make the play, but too bad he was throwing off of his back foot, and it got away from him a little bit, and he threw it over the head of his receiver.
Johnston has just not had any time to get a firm feet holding and throw the ball. I'd have to say maybe two or three times he's actually been able to stay in his pocket and has been flushed out by a slew of VSU defensive linemen. It's now 3rd and 7, ball in the 8, 14:55 here in the fourth quarter. 35-0 VSU commanding lead. Tigers trying to put together some sort of a drive. They have driven halfway down the field, and now His quarterback is outside of the pocket, rolling to the right. Juked two defenders and is brought down hard by three VSU defenders at the 5-yard line.
Was freshman Matt Pierce was also in on the tackle there to make sure that he didn't get into the end zone. But the freshman showing some pretty impressive moves on the outside edge to shake a couple defenders and try to get a little bit closer to the end zone.
Fourth down and three, ball on the four. Tigers. Tigers look like they are going to go for it. Try and put six on the board instead of three. Gary Johnston leading his team down the field, putting together this drive. 80 in motion. Johnston looking for it. Defenders all over him in the backfield. Wobbly, quick shovel pass to no one. And that is incomplete. Turnover. VSU gets the ball. First down on their own 3-yard line.
Number 33, Chauncey DeBose, was in the backfield. He was one of the first Blazers in Johnston's face to make sure he wasn't able to get that pass off.
14 minutes and 6 seconds left here in the fourth and final quarter here at Bazemore-Hyder Stadium. It's 35-0, VSU on top. Looks like second team offense still out there. They're coming onto the field. Russ Calloway, number 5, leading the charge for them. In the backfield, we have number 10, David Arnold. Russ Calloway gets the snap, handoff to David Arnold right up the middle, trucks through two defenders and picks up a gain of about 3-yard line. It'll be 2nd and 7 for the Valdosta State Blazers. It's 13:55 left here in the fourth quarter.
Arnold rushes for a gain of about 3 on the play at 2nd down and 7.
2nd and 7 on the 7-yard line for VSU. Calloway yelling at his players, changing the play, waiting for the snap. Gets a snap, handoff, fake handoff to David Arnold. Pat looking, running, rolling out right, looking for a pass, wobbly pass through the air, out the sideline. I think his target was 84, Jackson Dean.
That was number 46, Marquez Coleman, putting the pressure on Calloway to make sure he got rid of the ball instead of going downfield for completion.
Again, Russ Calloway dealing with at least two Tiger defenders in his face almost immediately once it is snapped. Offsides by the defense. Long, deep throw by Russ Calloway to Cedric Jones, and it is broken up. No, it's not Cedric Jones that caught it. That would be
Owen Dixon
that was intended to. Broken up by Tiger defenders. Flag on the field, though. Offsides by the defense. VSU will get 5 yards. Third down and 2. Ball on the VSU 6-yard line.
And I expect the Blazers to give it to Mr. David Arnold here to try to pound it up the middle to get the first down.
Russ Calloway waiting for the snap, yelling stuff to his wide receivers. Jackson Dean and Isaiah Jupiter lined up on the near side. David Arnold in motion. Russ sees the snap, looking for a target. Quick throw to number 84, Jackson Dean. Great catch, picks up a couple more yards. It was a first down play for the Valdosta State Blazers.
And they're doing what you expect them to do, to get out here and try to keep the clock moving, try to go ahead and finish up this game so they can stay home with the victory.
Russ Calloway, quick snap directly to number 9. Oh no, number 9, Owen Dixon, fumbles the ball, picked up by a UWA Tiger defender, recovered by the Tigers. That is a fumble by Owen Dixon. Tigers recover on the VSU 17-yard line. Automatic red zone possession for the Tigers.
And that was number 29, Brandon Tisdale, that picked up the fumble and took it back until he was brought down from behind by number 10, David Arnold.
Unfortunate for the Blazers. That's their second lost fumble during this game, possibly even their third. That's been a big problem right now for the Blazers, holding on to the ball. Rain has stopped for a good couple hours, so wetness on the field, not a factor. Just could be sloppy play and complaintiness with a 35-0 lead. VSU defense back on the field. Tigers ready, set up in the slot. Gary Johnston receives the snap, fake handoff, looking for someone open.
Quick pass to number 7, Terry Allen, runs up the sideline for a gain of about 6 or 5 yards. Definitely well short of a Tigers first down. Valdosta State leading this matchup here at Bazemore-Hyder Stadium. It is 35-0 with just under 13 minutes to play in this final quarter. Second and 11. That was a negative play by Terry Allen for his Tigers. So it's second and 11, ball on the 18. Josh Bass, Gary Johnston back. Handoff up the middle. Gain of no yards by number 9, Damian Baylor. Starting running back for the Tigers, finally in there, finally seeing some action after after his backup has been seeing a lot of play, especially over the past couple drives. Tigers setting up again, trying to get some sort of points on the score, trying to get rid of that ugly-looking goose egg for him. Gary Johnson directing traffic. Waiting for the snap, man in motion, number 7, Terry Allen. Handoff to number 9, Damian Baylor, right up the middle, no gain on the play.
And this is something you don't really expect to see from Damian Baylor. Damian Baylor came into this game tonight averaging over 66 yards on the ground, where tonight he's only had 8 attempts. Well, that was his 9th attempt right there, but he only had 20 just before that carry, and he got nowhere, so he's 9 attempts for 20 yards.
And I think this is the first time we've seen him handle the ball in the second half. Tigers lined up again. Roosevelt Ross back in the game. Tigers look like they're trying to keep it with Ross. Little short pass to the left. Number 3 has his hands on it, Michael Townsend, but he drops it, possibly because he heard the pitter-patter of Blazer defenders right behind him.
Or it could be because the quarterback was forced to make a bad throw, even though I didn't see anyone around him. Maybe he felt as if there was someone behind him, so he got rid of the ball.
That's where inexperience can kill a football team.
I mean, after being harassed by this VSU defense all night, I'm pretty sure he expected someone to be there.
First and 10 for the Valdosta State Blazers. 11:18 left in the fourth quarter, 35-0 VSU on top. They will be starting on their own 13-yard line. Second team offense still in the game. Russ Calloway directing everything going on. We have number 10, David Arnold in the backfield, receives the handoff and is just pancaked and stopped. Negative yardage on that play, possibly negative yards of 1 or 2. If he got back to the line of scrimmage, he is extremely lucky.
And Kellen Lewis has earned himself the last half of this game off. Tonight he was 27 of 37 on passing with 306 yards and rushed for 2 touchdowns.
Very good numbers for Lewis. Very good numbers. Blazers snap, a little shovel pass to number 25, Michael Brown. Big run for him up the right side, breaking through defenders, makes a quick spin, and he is seeing nothing but green. He's at the 30, at the 25, 20. He's now at the 20, brought down at the 10. Oh, number 25, Michael Brown, with a monstrous, monstrous run there. He saw nothing but green for a while. Unfortunately, Tiger defenders caught up with him and took him down.
And this is what the Blazers deep offense does to you. They have the big guys in, and then they bring in little guys like Michael Brown, as you see here, who are extremely fast, make a couple moves there to break down defenders and break it out to the outside, and he picks up good yardage, breaks the tackle right there, just spins around a little bit, and he takes it straight on downfield until he stops.
Amazing footwork by Michael Brown. Oh. Russ Calloway, quick little pitch to
number 84, Jackson Dean.
Doesn't make the play, though. That would be incomplete, bringing up second and 10. Ball on the 12 for Valdosta State. 35-0 VSU on top with 10:30 left here in the fourth quarter. Great play by Michael Brown. Really moving his feet, getting past defenders. Russ Calloway waiting for the snap, takes it, hand off to number 2. Derek Harris doesn't get out of the backfield. Loss of 1 on the play, bringing up 3rd and 11 on the 13 for VSU. Almost 10 minutes left here in the game. VSU still extraordinarily commanding lead, 35-0. Tigers have tried for the past two, have gotten into the red zone on their past two drives, but still goose egg on the score for them. Russ Callaway awaiting the snap. Gets it, looking for a man, finds number six, R.J. Bastone, for a gain of four or five yards on the play. That'll bring up fourth down.
And R.J. Bastone is one of those other Blazers receivers who has been having a pretty lights out night here today.
Fourth and five for the Blazers. Looks like they are going to go for it. Why not, though? When you're 35 to nothing, might as well try it. Russ Callaway directing traffic, number two. Derek Harris in the backfield for him. We got Jackson Dean and Cody Case along with Isaiah Jupiter on the near side. And alone is R.J. Bastone on the far side. Oh, immediate pocket pressure for Russ Callaway. He is being twirled and hurled around, and he is sacked. He is just brought down for a monstrous loss. A loss of looks like a good 15 yards for Russ Callaway and the VSU Blazers. And that would be an automatic turnover to the Tigers. They will start.
And as you can see here, number 10 was able to get the hand on Russ Callaway. Number 10, Eric Hendricks, and make sure he didn't let him get away.
There was a penalty flag on that play. Illegal formation on the Blazers. It is declined. First down for the Tigers. 35-0 still the score. 9:12 left in the game. Their Tigers will be starting on their 25th yard line.
And it's starting to rain again here at Bazemore-Hyder Stadium.
We're going to take a quick break. 9:12 left to play. 35-0 VSU on top. This is VSU-TV.
Valdosta, more than you know. A place where kids dream and kind hearts prevail. In a setting full of recreation and excitement for all ages. A city of vibrant growth, career opportunities, and a thriving business environment. Combined with progressive thinking, it's about exploring your future. Valdosta, Georgia, more than you know.
Welcome back to the action here at Bazemore-Hyder Stadium. 9:12 left, 35-0. VSU defense on the field. Complete miscommunications by the Tigers. The ball was bobbled by, looked like two people. Finally, quarterback comes down with a Gary Johnson. Negative yardage on that, not if you could even call that a play. Looked like it was broken from the start. 8:50 left in the ball game. Second down and nine, ball in the 26th for the West Alabama Tigers. Gary with the snap, hands it off to number 23, Roosevelt Ross, right up the gut. Gain of one or two if he's lucky. Just a sea of VSU defenders is what greeted him once he got past the offensive line.
Even though it looks like the Blazers already have the win in hand, the defense is not letting up. They're still playing 100 miles a minute and making sure that they don't give up any touchdowns here at the end of the game.
Jared Warsham and Damian Baylor lined up on the near side for the West Alabama Tigers. Johnson with a throw out to number eight. Randy Lowry makes the catch, gains a few yards, and is pushed out of bounds by the Blazers.
It's number 31, Ryan Smith, the freshman linebacker in there on the tackle. And as the rain starts to pour down here at Bazemore-Hyder Stadium, it might make things a little bit more difficult for the passing game, or they might try to go to the ground. We'll see how the rain affects their game plan here.
West Alabama Tigers looking at a first and 10 ball on their own 35-yard line. Just under 8 minutes left in the game. West Alabama trying to put together that once a scoring drive for their game, trying to leave Valdosta, leave Titletown with something more than a goose egg on the score. Hand off to Roosevelt Ross up the middle, no gain again. VSU defensive line has really, really held their rushing game.
And that's what you want to see from the Valdosta State defensive line. Coming into this game, the defensive side of the ball was only giving up, I want to say, 84 yards on the ground, which is pretty good. But they got blasted against Wichita for 144 yards on the ground by K.J. Johnson, so they're trying to make up for that tonight.
Gary Johnson back, ready to receive the snap. Receives it, hand off. No, it's quarterback keep. A little fake running out to the left. Caught the defense off guard, but they quickly found the ball, tackled him, gain of three on the play. Third and two for the West Alabama Tigers. 6:49 left in the game, 35-0 still the score. VSU, very, very commanding game. 6:30
6 left here in the game, 35-0, third and 2. Ball on the 43-yard line for the West Alabama Tigers. Gary Johnston receives the snap, run to the left, pitch to 23 Roosevelt Ross. Oh, brutal stiff arm, another stiff arm, and he's forced out of bounds. He put a lick on number 42 of the Blazers. Number 12 of the Blazers, Gary of the Blazers, Stevie Harden. It was pushed hard and deep into the West Alabama sidelines, falling over multiple coolers.
Here you see on the play, Johnston with the pitch to number 23, and he stiff arms number 42 there to make sure he gets to the outside and try to pick up the yardage, and then he was tackled by number 12, Stevie Harden, and both ran into the fence right down the sidelines.
Very surprised the refs didn't throw a flag on that play. Looks like he had been tackling them continuously out of bounds.
It was the momentum of the play. If you throw a flag on that, I mean, it's kind of bad because it was the momentum of the play. He really couldn't stop once he got going.
Gary Johnston receives a snap, handoff to Roosevelt Ross up the middle, gain of about 6 on the play.
Ross carries up the middle once again, gain of about 5 on the play.
Second and 5 for the West Alabama Tigers. Ball on the VSU 48-yard line. 5:46 left in the game. VSU blanking West Alabama 35-0.
I think they're just trying to get at least one score on the board to get back some of the more dignity here, Mike.
I can't set it any better, Trey. Gary Johnston trying to work this offense into something. Gets the snap, deep pass. Oh, met by 2 VSU defenders as he tries to get the ball to number 6, Gerald Worsham. VSU all over the ball as soon as it came into the air.
He was just trying to do what most quarterbacks do, get the ball into the hands of the playmakers, and hopefully they'll make something happen at the other end.
Third and 5, ball on the 48-yard line, 35-0, still the score, 5:21 left in the game. West Alabama getting the play from the sideline, Johnston relaying it to his team. Allen and Tony Taylor in the backfield, handoff to Taylor. No, fake handoff to Taylor, flip to Allen. Juked our defender at the 50, breakaway off the right side line, stopped at the 32-yard line. There is a flag on the play. We'll see how this affects the play.
And it looked like it might have been holding. Yes, it was holding on the West Alabama side of the ball, so this one will be coming back.
So we'll be coming back, and they'll be getting a 3rd and 15 ball on the 48-yard line.
And that was the star wide receiver, Greg Worsham, there trying to make a play for number 7, Terry Allen, to let him get to the outside and try to pick up the first down, but he held on just a little too long to the VSU defender.
Seems the Tigers are trying to fake out the VSU defense. There have been multiple fake passes and fake handoffs. Just trying to get something, just trying to get some sort of score on the board. Johnston again leading the charge. 4:50 left on the clock. Fake handoff, and oh, Johnston is sacked by number 41.
Alec Williams.
Great play by the VSU defense. Again, immediately in the backfield as soon as the ball was hiked.
And that didn't look good for the freshman quarterback there. It looked like he might have got rolled up on that play and might have hurt himself, but he seems to be fine. He's walking to the sideline now, and it's 4-9 for the West Alabama, and looks like they're going to send the punt team out to give it back to the Blazers.
Number 80, Chris Wellborn back, awaiting the kick for the Blazers. Tigers punter Kyler Kimbrough, or Brock Sharp. Low kick, sailing through the air, fair catch called by number 80 Wellhorn, and it will be VSU ball on the VSU 12-yard line. The American Red Cross is looking for donors in the Valdosta area to set up and help with the blood shortage. Viruses such as H1N1 have contributed to growing shortages, and the Red Cross is in need of all blood types. To set up an appointment, call 1-800-GIVE-LIFE or go to givelife.org. Second team offense for the Blazers back on the field. Russ Calloway leading the charge. Number 10, David Arnold in the backfield for the Blazers. Hand off to David Arnold up the middle. Hit hard. Wobbles past the defender for another gain of about
5 yards on the play.
That's something you rarely see from a big halfback. He was able to keep his footing on this play. As you see, he gets the ball, Hans takes it straight up the middle. He gets hit right there, but he was able to keep his footing and take it up for a couple more yards.
Good run by the VSU offense. 35-0, still the score. 3:39 left in the game. VSU looking like they're just going to keep running the ball to keep that clock moving and get this game over with. Second down, one to go. Ball on the 21-yard line. Russ Callaway just taking his time, waiting for the clock to expire. 6 seconds left on the play clock. Ball snapped. Hand off to David Arnold. Run up the middle again. That is a definite first down and a gain of at least 6 more yards after the first down.
And the Blazers are just ready to go ahead and call the night. That's why they're going to keep the ball on the ground and keep David Arnold in there to pound it up the middle and make sure they keep picking up first downs to go ahead and get the game over.
And with that run, the clock will tick below the 3-minute mark. 35-0 is the score. First and 10 for the Blazers on their own 27-yard line. Blazers coming out of the huddle. Wellborn and Kurt Deal on the near side of the field. Hand off to David Arnold up the middle again. Gain of about 3 yard lines. That'll give the Blazers second and 7. Just past their own 30-yard line with 2:30 left to play in the game. Blazers are up big 35-0.
Roosevelt Ross is playing pretty well tonight, even though it was in a losing effort. Coming into this game, he's averaged over 50 yards on the ground, but tonight he's had 15 attempts for 97 yards. That's pretty impressive, isn't it, Mike?
Absolutely, especially against a Blazer defense that is clicking on all cylinders today. Russ Callaway and the Blazers break the huddle. David Arnold in the backfield again with Russ Callaway. Hand off again to David Arnold right at the middle. Breaks two tackles and a fumble. Ball is hit right out of his hands. West Alabama recovers and takes it all the way down to VSU 10-yard line. Tigers will get the ball first and 10 in the red zone on VSU 10-yard line. Costly mistake for the VSU offense and David Arnold with that fumble.
And that was number 31 to Tavarius Finley for the Tigers that picked the ball up and took it back down to almost around the 10-yard line.
Great hit by the Tiger defense. Hit David Arnold right on the ball and it popped right loose about 5 yards in front of him, and there was nothing he could do. There was Tiger defenders everywhere and they immediately jumped on the bell. During the play, there was a penalty on the field. Personal foul on the Tigers. They'll only get half the distance to the goal after picking up that fumble play. It's 2nd and 7 for the Tigers.
Following the penalty, the Tigers will have 1st and goal at the 5-yard line.
Excuse me, they are 1st and goal on the 5-yard line. Tigers in the red zone. Ball on the 5-yard line, trying to erase that big goose egg that's still on the score for the Tigers. 35-0, VSU leading with 1:48 left to play. We're going to take a quick break here on VSU-TV.
Hi, I'm Kathy Casey Kirschling, the nation's first baby boomer. Like millions of boomers, I'm busy and my time is important to me. So when I became eligible to apply for Social Security, I did it online and it was so easy. So when it's your time to apply, save yourself a trip to an office. Apply online at www.socialsecurity.gov. It's fast, it's easy, above all, secure.
Welcome back to Bazemore-Hyder Stadium. Valdosta State commanding lead, 35-0. First down and 5 for the Tigers. Red zone attempt. They're trying to get some resemblance of a score on the board. So far they have been blanked through almost the entire game.
And this is as close as the Tigers have been to scoring all night, Mike.
And just think, this setup came off a fumble by VSU. Quarterback hands off to number 23, Russell Ross, who charges up the right sideline for a touchdown. University of West Alabama has finally joined the game and is on the scoreboard. 35-6 is the current score.
As you can see here on the highlight, he hands it off to Roosevelt, who was able to make number looked like 50. There's 51. Tommy Duhart missed right there on the tackle, and he was able to cut the corner, run straight in, dive for the end zone. He got across the plane to make it a touchdown.
West Alabama lining up for extra point attempt. Number 28, Tyler Kimbrough, awaiting to kick. Ball snapped. Ball is up. Ball is no good. Score 35-6 with a minute 40 left to play.
This has been a very impressive game by the Valdosta State Blazers. They were able to put together a complete game for the first time in a long time that I've seen the Blazers play here at Bazemore-Hyder Stadium. The offense was clicking on all cylinders. The defense was able to go out and get all the stops necessary until the very end of the game, and I'm just completely impressed by it.
Minute 40 left here at Bazemore-Hyder Stadium, 35 seconds to go. And you're right, Trey, they have put some really good numbers on the board. 31 rushes for 75 yards, and in the air, 413 passing yards for the Valdosta State offense.
As well as they've only done 77 plays for 488 yards, and the game is still not over.
Very impressive to see this Valdosta defense. Vote 2009, a local political forum, will air during the month of October, beginning on October 4th at noon. Get informed with Vote 2009, local political debates only on VSU-TV.
And those are the sounds of the Carroll High School marching. Sir, make a band, you hear there, Mike. Trying to get the what's left of the crowd into the game and get on their feet to support the Blazers for this last minute and 40 seconds.
Minute 40 left, like Trey said, 35-6. Blazers awaiting the kickoff. It's going to be an onside kick. Tigers trying anything at all, and you can't blame them. Number 27 lining up for this onside kick. Brock Sharp trying to do this. And, oh, not a onside kick, but a full-on kickoff. Ronnie Nelson fields the ball, waits for the defenders, and kneels it. VSU will get starting position on their own 18-yard line with 1:30 left to play, and VSU leading 35-6. Going back to VSU's numbers, looking at their average play, they are averaging 6.3 yards a play. But looking down farther, you see a big number, 13 penalties for 85 yards. Fortunately, that has not come back to bite the VSU Blazers, but you can't have that many penalties, especially with opponents such as Delta State and University of North Alabama looming in the not-so-distant future. VSU kneels the ball, trying to just wind this game down. Clock is ticking. Now dropping below 1:30 left in the game. 35-6 is the score. VSU winning.
Another thing that made a very drastic change as the game went on was at the beginning, well, going into the halftime, the Blazers almost doubled the time of possession with West Alabama. Now it's 29 minutes and 27 seconds for the Blazers, whereas West Alabama has had the ball for 28 minutes and 53 seconds.
Very impressive. Looks like the freshman quarterback for West Alabama actually has helped the team out. He was the only one that has led them on a scoring drive. Deion Williams couldn't even get into the red zone whenever he was playing against the VSU defense, who came out to play today.
And with that touchdown, Roosevelt Ross was able to go over for 100 yards on the ground. He had 16 attempts for 102 yards and that one touchdown.
But still, the big name of the night, Cedric Jones, with 10 catches, 90 yards, and a touchdown, moving him up in the record books. Congratulations, Cedric. Kneeling the ball, VSU is ending this game. That's right, the clock is going to just tick on down. 20 seconds left. VSU is poised to win this game 35-6. We've got 10 seconds left. And players are coming onto the field. The game is over.
And with this win, the Blazers are now 2-2 on the season, as well as 2-1 in the GSC. And depending upon the outcome of the Delta State Wachita Baptist game, the Blazers can either be tied for third in the GSC or tied for the fourth.
So no matter how you look at it, very good day for Blazer football. Very good day.
Well, that's the end of the game here at Bazemore-Hyder Stadium, where the score is 35-6, but the Blazers getting a big win. That's the end of the game, and I hope you guys enjoyed it.